play both sides. Too low in my life, gotta stay high, gotta stay high. Too low in my life, yeah, I gotta stay. Hate it when they play both sides. Too low in my life, so I gotta stay high, yeah, I gotta stay high. Too low in my, too low in my. Counting the racks up, I got my stacks up. Bad little bitch, tell her back up. In the cut with the Mac tuck, run up on me, get hit up. Ambulance need to pick them up. Six shots to the head like, whoa. Run through the six, no walls. No money, no hands, no balls. Up, down, left, right, A, B, G, code. Pull up my gun, sing like Lee Show. Rick going in my coat, no superhero. BVS my wrist like Sub-Zero. Play a bitch like guitar, no hero. Running money up, stack it like Legos. Bad bitch wanna fuck, I say Lego. R.I.P. to my niggas gone. Sometimes I wish I could hit your phone. I don't really wanna walk through life alone. Ain't too many real niggas here no more. I lost my woody, my heart cold. Now I gotta walk through life alone. Now I gotta walk through life alone. Now I gotta live this life alone. Hate it when they play both sides. Too low in my life, gotta stay high, gotta stay high. Too low in my life, yeah, I gotta stay. Hate it when they play both sides. Too low in my life, so I gotta stay high, yeah, I gotta stay high. Too low in my, too low in my.
Walk hard in my body, I can't help myself. I get so damn high that I can't feel myself. My girlfriend worried about me, think I'm gon' kill myself. Sorry, baby, I'm just really tryna feel myself. Keep my head above the water while I drown in well. I got that drip like Gunna, I may drip or drown myself. You know I love choppers, I had to surround myself. Taking gelato to the head, smoke to pound myself.
Hate it when they play both sides. Too low in my life, gotta stay high, gotta stay high. Too low in my life, yeah, I gotta stay. Hate it when they play both sides. Too low in my life, so I gotta stay high, yeah, I gotta stay high. Too low in my, too low in my.
Well, I can feel myself, I never worried about anything, I don't kill myself. Sorry, I'm just really trying to feel myself.
Hey, shout out around the motherfucking building, though, you already know. Hey, shout out big homie El Santana, my homie Pratik Sharma in the building, you already know. He said, happy smoking from the Philippines, that's what I'm talking about, man, the big city. That's what I'm talking about, man, way too litty, worldwide litty, with this shit right here, nigga.
Sometimes it feels like I can't die,
cause I never was alive. That's my shit. So about to roll this backwood. Let's get high as shit. Like, hey, you already know, you know what I'm saying? As a matter of fact, you know what I'm saying? I got a few hits left in this motherfucking cart. I'm about to tear this motherfucker up. Cause if y'all don't know what this cart be taking me in the outer space, bro. I gotta get some more, bro. My homie be making these shits, man. Made. Source, like I said, look, the weed's grown here in North Carolina. It's blasted here in North Carolina and fucking Cartsfield in North Carolina. Like, everything in North Carolina, not no Virginia, not New York, not old. My homie took a fucking trip to DC, took a few Cartsfield to work. Nah, motherfucking North Cackalacky, bruh. Right here, right down the street. Goddamn, my mouthpiece started getting clogged up. It's the end of the motherfucking joint, though. You know how it go.
Yeah, let me in.
Sometimes it feels like I can't die, cause I never was alive. Every day it feels like someone new dies. Hope the news is a lie. This is my version of watching you.
Sheesh, try to go to Yodi Land. How y'all living in the building though? Oh, she's in North Carolina. You get any free to baby tickets? Hell yeah, bro. They send them in the mail. Like, you know, news, but like, you know, in the fucking, like, phone books and shit be covered in. You know, everybody get a free phone book. In that phone book, bro, you get, like, tickets to each the baby concert, bro. Like, on each page, they just be hiding in that motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? But shout out to everybody. The motherfucking building, though. Let me catch up on chat. Hold on, I gotta catch up on chat. Y'all blew it down for a second. Even motherfucking OBS couldn't catch up that cheap ass shit. So, hey, Larry, haven't caught you live forever. Hey, Miss Kelsey in the building. How's you living? How's you been? Hope you've been living litty. Hope you've been living a life as beautiful as you are. Hey, hey. was alive. Sheesh, sheesh. Then I was just kidding. I'm smoking carts too. Exactly, bro. We gotta hit them carts, bro. What you talking about, bro? We gotta push them carts.
Pushing carts.
So every citizen, like, bro, we do, bro. They do. Like, I mean, come on now.
Coffee Black in the building.
So I'm looking vibrant tonight. Chief CJ, you already know. Nice and healthy in the building. So where's the marijuana layer? Man, shit, I got some of this good old cart over here. You know what I'm saying? And I got some of this fire CBD. You know what I'm saying?
Where my jar at, though?
I got some Kush in the building. So don't be worried. Don't be fretting. I got Kush. I got Kush.
Shit. Right now, fucking, you know, I got a grinder of some shit already rolled up. Not rolled up. Goddamn grinded up. Got some motherfucking, let's say, look, I got some of the CBD and THC in this motherfucker. You know what I'm saying?
Had to fucking combine this shit. You know what I'm saying? You combine this shit, it's another level. Some old CBD bug, man. Shit. I packed a bowl for the homie the other day. Like I said, bro, if you pull a homie, you get fried. Had a grinder, this same shit right here, you know what I'm saying? I put like 75% THC buds in that motherfucker. Then, you know what I'm saying, topped it off with some CBD. And motherfucking mixed that shit up. Some like goddamn heavy CBD too. That shit like what, 20-something%? Yeah, that motherfucker on Pizzlin, you know what I'm saying? Most CBDs you get like 18, 16, 50, all that shit, you know what I'm saying? That's like 20-something. That motherfucker on fire, you know what I'm saying? That shit'll get you nice and chill. Man, I packed a couple bowls for the homie, you already know. Homie had a goddamn... Can't do it. I said, hell yeah, bro. Homie was fried in the motherfucker. First bowl, you know what I'm saying, had him opened up, you know what I'm saying? That second one just put him on the floor.
Y'all think it's a joke? It's a CBD.
Man, see, I can tell what you guys, man, like, I don't know, man. I thought you guys were seasoned smokers, like, seasoned down to, like, tea. Like, you gotta be a rookie if you ain't rocking with the CBD. Like, what kind of world are you living in?
Don't sleep on CBD. I'm an indica type of guy, but there's a strain called CBD Yummy. It's, if you especially look for shit lit. So when you mix them, they work together, synergy.
Exactly, bro. Like, people don't understand that. The effects of THC and CBD, you ain't never seen it before. Like, what kind of world we living in? All the weed, with the weed you smoke, has CBD in it. It got a little bit. If it didn't have a little bit of CBD in it, your whole THC experience wouldn't be so amazing. You know what I'm saying? It's a list that combination, man. What world y'all living in? So I'll finish another night shift. One more till I'm off, time to pop a beer and fire a couple buzzes. It's OJ Kush. For the OJ Z Kush. Oh, that's another world. They done threw another leather on that bitch. So for the legend, Mac. Man, you already know. Big Mac with the extra sauce. Exactly. Put my favorite one. Mac Miller Weekend. That's my track right here. I fuck with this track too heavy. Hey, as a matter of fact, we played the video. Fuck copyright. We don't give a damn. We G's up in this bitch, bro. Mac Miller, one of the greatest to ever do it. He one of the greatest to ever pick up a motherfucking mic. Say good choice, brother. Hell yeah, bro. That's one of my favorite tracks by Mac, bro. One of my favorite tracks overall, but definitely one of my favorite tracks by Mac.
Going by the weekend. So CBD is like a fine topping, like Keith alone. It's okay.
Yeah, I mean, hey, you know what I'm saying? I wouldn't be smoking some CBD just by itself, you know what I'm saying? Hey, I mean, this is one of those days, you know what I'm saying? Like, where that's just what it is. I remember I was like, you know, hanging out with homies one day, and my homie had one of those CBD pre-rolls. And he endorsed them. He said they're pretty good when he just wants something to smoke, but he don't want to get fried, you know what I'm saying? Like, I can understand it, you know what I'm saying? A lot of times, you gotta understand, man. Most of us old, bro. We get old, like, we can't just be smoking dank to the head all goddamn day, bro. We got shit to do. So, you know what I'm saying? When you goddamn get that THC mixed with that good CBD, that shit really coats you out, bro. You know what I'm saying? That CBD is nice and relaxing. And that THC, you know, is all, you know, hitty and flitty, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, Alana's is okay, but mixed, the only strain I like is CBD. Is it CBD yummy? I'll be good by the weekend. Hey, okay, I got this motherfucker. Which one is this one? See, this, oh yeah, the Cherry Ultra. This shit is lit, bro. It's Cherry Ultra, bro. It tastes just like a cherry. Like, you know what I'm saying? That shit on the whole mother. whole mother level. Hold on, we going out tonight. Yeah, we going out tonight. Like, fuck it. So you from Portland, come fuck with me if you ever want to sit here and get breath. I'm gonna be up in the motherfucking building, bro. I'm gonna fuck with everybody in the big city. What the fuck is going on? Bro, I did not call Siri, dude. The bitch over here is like, bro. I don't know if it's like iOS 80,000, whatever they call this shit, or what the fucking problem is. But Siri's so motherfucking sensitive now. I can just be saying anything. Like, I can be singing, and that bitch will pop up. You know what I'm saying? You say words with an S. It's like, what? Off the hate me. Never will I walk in line across the T's and dot the I's. Only way well. Little bit how I got this. I was asleep and forgot the dollar. Goddamn. Woo, woo. Now this is chasing the dollar. Faded. Ayy. How did I make it? This bitch is getting naked. Lord, I know what the day is. But I'm good about a. I'll be good about a weekend. Everything good about your weekend. Be good by your weekend. By your weekend. I should have mentioned genetics. This is the UK genetics. Hey, from the UK, the big city. The big titty. Hell yeah, man. Well, that's why there's a little weed, man. A little weed from every country, every city. You know what I'm saying? George, I'm overdosing on CBD right now. Hey, man. I know you mad, relaxed, mad, chill. It's like a peaceful day. So, finally cleaning the banger out between hits with ISO. No more burnt ass rubber taste. Yes, you know you gotta clean that shit. And I cleaned it, man. Bet I be good about it. Best weed by the states. Hey, man. You already know Cali. Cali got it on a headlock, if you ask me. But, I mean, you know, I haven't been to a whole lot of, well, shit, even legal states, whatever. State. Oklahoma was lit. Oklahoma was a lot better than you think. Oklahoma has some gas, okay? When we were out in Oklahoma, like, as soon as we got, you know, there, the homies had a fucking, like, they basically was taking our order before we had got there, so they had everything ready type shit, and one of their plugs pulled up, it was this fine-ass white chick, like, you know what I'm saying? Like bro, Oklahoma's down, litty as fuck, oh, it look litty as fuck already, he got badass white chick pulling a delivering kush and shit, and I mean kush too, like, you know what I'm saying? Packs, I was like, holy shit, isn't it? You know what I'm saying? You know, that weed that's so, it's so covered in trikes, and shit look great. Gray, you know what I'm saying? Like, motherfucker look gray, like shit, like purpley gray. Like, that motherfucker like a dehydrated purple. That shit be on pizzling, bro. That be a whole nother level, you know what I'm saying? See, a whole lot of people got their colors, got the green, lime green, whatever, dark yellow, bro. When you get to that motherfucking, that purplish grayish kind of shit, like, and that shit striky, stinky, and resiny, all that shit. Oh, yeah, those make for some of the best blunts in the world. You fire up a blunt of that, man, that shtyak yabby yak yay. That's that shtyak yabby yak yay right there. That's that shtyak yabby yak yay. Also, liquor sherbet took off down here. I want to get some Cali stuff, throw up a Christmas after some permanent marker and some trap pussy. Okay, hey, I like that the names are still getting silly. Like, for a minute, weed names were kind of getting a little boring. I like how we getting back to the crazy shit that you would have heard back in the 90s. Like, you know, the weed, like, way back when, it was better. Like, in the late 90s, early 2000s, the weed was better when it had a crazy-ass name. You know what I mean? Blue Dream, OG Kush, that's nice. But that purple nurple and that wedgie juice, all this shit, you know what I'm saying? This shit, you already know. Get you blow your forehead off, like, you know what I'm saying? That's that real. I'll tell you the best, but they been from Cali. Yeah, when I got off the plane, I went to this spot with the homies. And I picked up some of this shit called Do-Si-Do. Not Do-Si-Do. Fuck a Do-Si-Do. It's called Delato. It was called Delato OG. And it's a cross between Do-Si-Do and Gelato. And that shit was lit. That shit was super fire with a cape on it. That's the bud I was taking around to everybody, like, because I caught a little bit. I think I caught, like, 5 grams of it when I got off the plane or whatever. So, you know, I had a little bit for a little second or two, you know what I'm saying? And, yeah, like, I remember I was just taking around to everybody that I was meeting in L.A., all the homies and all that shit I was meeting up with. And, you know, I, like, hey, that's what I got, popping a jar on them, bro. Everybody else popping this shit. I was like, oh, this shit lit, this shit crazy. When you get that, like, not even just on some,
oh yeah, good weed. They were really like mind blown. Like, where the fuck you get that from? Like, nigga, down the street, yo street. You know what I'm saying? I don't give a fuck where I pull up at, man. Anywhere in the world, I'm gonna source out some good weed. You know what I'm saying? Some fire, no lie. I mean, I was smoking niggas out. Little EBZ. I pulled up on EBZ, bro. I had better weed than him. EBZ's like, man, my weed alright. we shit. Cause I rolled up like two joints of mine. And goddamn, he pulled out his bong and we were hitting some, you know what I'm saying, some bowls. He had his shit, you know, like in the grinder. He was like, yeah, man, my weed alright. Realistically, I like, mean, my shit trash. It was kind of boinky, man. I was like, wow, EBZ. He said EBZ has sticks and Ray VZ just had some questionable weed, bro. Like, he had some weed. I was like, bro, you live in LA? How? That shit didn't make no sense. How you live in LA and weed like this? I get off the plane. I'm from North Carolina, nowhere. And I get off the plane and get some fire. And you over here fucking with this shit. So I like the song you posted. Like, hey, big appreciations, Kelsey. You already know we out here trying to make it every day. We making it. And I said, Mama, I made it. I want to say, Mama, Mama, I got $1 billion. I want to call, I want to call Billie Eilish my mama. Now, that's a quality mama. That's a quality mama is right there. Y'all don't know nothing about that. Whoop. That's a track right here for the folks that ain't heard. Y'all already know. Come on, tell me how you feeling, let go. Hey, we need to shoot a video for that, man. We shoot a video for this shit going to the moon. I'll be showing you the best weed in Europe. Hey, yo. From the knuckle to the cookie store and live here. Rose, that shit trash. Yeah, look, that's the thing. I'm not going to cookie and all that shit like that, bro. I'm going to the fire ass dispensaries. Not even say hole in the wall, but the dispensaries that everybody ain't going to. Not everybody, you know what I'm saying? But they got customers. You going there, they got customers and shit. And the main thing is the girls in that motherfucker. When you walk in there, the girls like bad and they inviting, especially if they high. Cause that, what was that, the first one? Nah, that was the second one we went to. It was when, oh, when I got the Gorilla Glue from. The one we got the Gorilla Glue from, shout out my nigga Howie. We pulled up to this motherfucking spot. When I pulled up, when Howie pulled up on me, he had fucking gas. He had SFV and he had Larry OG. He said, for my boy Larry, you know, I got that Larry. I said, oh shit, you know what I'm saying? Look, I got some of the greatest homies on the planet, man. I'm so blessed over it. I'm hopping off the plane, getting fucking invited to all this fire cushion. Presented all this bud and in and out fat burgers and shit. Like, come on, man. And when I see you, I can't even stop until I blink. Whoop. And every time I'm with you, girl, you know I gotta think. Is she mine? Do she got me on her mind all the time? That's a nine. Then I think, like, never mind my nirvana. The world spins like my fingers run as marijuana. Whoop. I'm smoking weed and I see so that Larry OG fight. Hell yeah, it was. I might be. Should have seen my face when she told me she liked me. Help me to take my pain away. I can't even. Every time I fade away, I think I'm gonna be, it's gonna be some absolutely insane sativa. Game's a personal girl with shit. She can't go. She all that I got. Hey, yeah, do she love me? Do she love me? I can tell it's a pipe dream, blue dream in my pipe. B, want you to be my wifey, and that's something I might see. Come on, tell me how you feel. Oh man, I hope y'all love that. But either way, yeah, man, I just love some fire ass strains, though, man. I love fire and strains, but that Gorilla Glue though, cause like I said, for that dispensary, it was this fire ass, like, it was this chicken, right, she was high as hell, but she was faded, and she was beautiful in that motherfucker, and she knew what she was talking about, you know what I'm saying, like, it wasn't just like how you go to the motherfucker at Lowe's and be like, hey, I'm looking for some fucking roofing screws, and they be like, oh, yeah, the roof got screws in it, I think probably some nails, and say, no, nigga, I'm talking about looking for that, oh, that, like, I don't know what the hell going on, the car parts, though, you know, they don't know shit about a car. Let me ask you all type of silly ass questions. You know what I'm saying? You supposed to be asking them shit. But yeah, goddamn, like, she knew exactly what was going on. And she was hiding the motherfucker. She was just around like, yeah, this is our OG. And it's like, blah, 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 blah. You know what I'm saying? You probably like this right here. And I'll be honest with her, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes you like, you'll look at a bud and it be littier than a titty. But then they motherfucking, you pop the joint, you smell that shit, and it smell like a horse's ass. Like, and not in a good way. You know what I'm saying? That's the best way I can
can't explain it. Sometimes we be smelling like a horse ass, and it's not good at all. Like, not that kind of gay. Like, oh, smell like a butthole. Like, nah, it's a bad version. You know what I'm saying? But that motherfucking what you call it? That goddamn that goddamn that gorilla glue. What makes it fire and what lets you know that you're fucking with some real glue is like, that shit is really, it got, like, it's sticky. And it's not sticky, yo, sticky. It's glue, nigga. Like, you break that shit down, that's it. Like, your fingers are glued together, you know what I'm saying? That's the best thing I love about Gorilla Glue. Like, you can't fake that shit. You can't lie about it. You can't tell those stories. That shit is real glue. So we got some of that glue rolled up in our blunt. Man, I'm telling you, just gassy and now motherfucker. That was a real Cali blunt. Whoop. Can you do something for me? Whoop. Can you hit a little rich flex for me? 21. I see why they made this fucking tape. This whole tape just a goddamn, what you call it? A damn, a strip club soundtrack. Ain't just some shit to play in the strip club with bitches to shake their ass all night. You know what I'm saying? We did a freestyle. Y'all need one? You require? Whoop! That's how you get shot. I DM in vanish mode. I do that shit. Whoop! Whoop! Took her panties off and this bitch. Whoop! Whoop! Wiggy whoop! All my S's ain't nothing. Them hoes busted. If my ops ain't ready. Yeah, just what, so you don't know if he can get hurt. I mean, like, realistically, when I smoke, like, that's how it gets. I mean, unless I'm smoking some, like, crazy ass wax and that, all that crazy shit, like, really, it's just getting high. You can roll blunt after blunt. At some point, you just high as hell. You know what I'm saying? That's it. But I swear I don't be just getting higher. Like, oh my God. No, I'm just, maybe you're higher for longer or the come down is heavier. I don't know what to call it. You know what I'm saying? Really, it's just sustaining. It's just sustaining your high. So you smoke fat ass blunt, and then 30 minutes later, an hour later, you smoke another fat ass blunt. And it really is just sustaining it, because you was getting ready to start coming down, like, in 2 hours or so. But you smoke another blunt, it's kind of just renewing your high. Or hitting another bong rip or some shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Gang shit, saw the gang shit. When I see a girl, she said that I was a favorite. Ooh, crying. Whoop. And the cut is for work. So hey, check out Young Dolph Key Glock. That's how. Key Glock and bro, one of my favorites, man. I fuck with Key Glock and Dolph way too heavy. You know what I'm saying? Niggas pushing PTSD. Yeah. Oh, that's a new one? Oh, that's a rap. Hey. It's too crazy, bro. Yeah. RIP the Flipper. Yeah, RIP be on me, Dolphin. That was crazy when bro died, man. Way too crazy. Cause I've been fucking with Dolphin. Wow, now. You know what I'm saying? Him and Kiko Lodge been fucking with dudes heavy. You know what I'm saying? Ooh, ooh. I smoke indicas until I get depressed and I switch to sativas. Hell yeah, man, you gotta do what you gotta do, man. You gotta smoke sativas, smoke. Look, I smoke hybrids. I'm a hybrid ass nigga, I ain't gonna lie to you. I love a hybrid. Ain't nothing better than a hybrid to me, you know what I mean? Love a hybrid. I love that little thing that she do on her throat, what, suck your penis? Oh. Yeah, yeah. Don't call me no more, bitch. I recruited all new hoes in December. Who she's got? Somebody, I feel like a lot of weed is hybrid now. Yeah, it is, Kelsey. I think that's the leading, you know, the leading grower nowadays, you know what I'm saying? Because, I mean, most people can, you can handle some hybrid, you know what I mean? It give you the best of both worlds, you know? Don't make you too, like, sedated. Don't make you too paranoid and hypey, gittery, and jittery. Like, it's just lit.
Yeah. me locked up. No cover nigga won't be dead. My dog on the way back to the feds. Two big bully bitches in the bed. These neighborhood diamonds, they blue. I used to go pack for my power room, nigga. I see you in 2 minute pictures. Austin is fuck you too, nigga. Rappers riding dick for clout. We don't do that every route. Bro, niggas can't come around. Didn't come up until I stayed down.
Blue diamonds, you when I slap. Everything. Cool dragon crystal. Hey, so exist as me. My shout out to the girls in the field. It could be the best to smoke after work. I'm chilling after that backwood. Hey, I smoke while working to go see my friend for a joint at about 3 a.m. Usually, to be honest, I use mouthwash and drink a lot of water to get rid of. Excuse me, nearly 4 hours. It's over. Hey, you got to do what you got to do, man. I ain't mad at you for 1 second. If it looks green, I'll smoke it. Hey, be careful, bro. That fentanyl coming all different shapes and sizes nowadays. All different colors, everything. As he falls, that's all you need. That cart been holding me for a minute now. I forgot when I got that shit. Hell, like longer than a week ago though. Definitely, what, as a matter of fact, it was a week ago. It was a second ago. I got that fucking cart out. A second ago, around like a couple weeks. That shit's strong, boy. Let me get a couple more though. I probably get a pack of them, man. Let me see you get a bit. You know what I'm saying? He'll be able to pack them for the low. Alright, with that, man, just had carts on carts, you know what I'm saying? I'll probably go ahead and do that too, you know what I'm saying? Whew. Go ahead and grab a box of them bitches, you know what I'm saying? Lord seeing me swerve, do this to my loved ones, I've got some nerve. Don't think I'm not sorry. Hey. Hear me now, Adrian's time, I'm ready for it. Can't stop this war in me, can't stop this war in me, me. Hear me now, Adrian's time, I'm ready for it. Can't fight this war in me, can't fight this war in me. I love this shit. So I tell my mom I'm sorry. Oh my. Can't stop this war in me, can't stop this war in me. If any institution doesn't allow my students to bring their bongs, I'm failing as a professional. Hey, man. You should be able to fucking vape cannabis anywhere you want to. Now we got this vape shit, you can be able to hit cannabis anywhere. And as a matter of fact, you can. I be in a motherfucking grocery store. Boop, boop, boop. Think I know. For what? Nah. It's vape. You know what I'm saying? That shit be gone in like 30 seconds. Realistically, though, you don't see me fucking vaping that live resin on that dank ass shit, boy. It take a second, but it'd be alright. You blow it up into the sky. It ain't smoke. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot different, so. Be in the motherfucker start tearing that shit up. And burn. Hold on. Hold on, hear me now, Adrian's time, I'm ready for it. Can't stop this war in me, can't stop this war in me. Hear me now, I fuck with this track. When I first did the shrooms, this is the track I thought about. Like, this is how shit felt, you know what I'm saying? Everything felt like this track. In Oklahoma, I think you can smoke wherever you are allowed to smoke a seed. Yeah, damn, that's pretty much nowhere. You can barely smoke a cig anywhere. Gotta be 800 feet away from buildings. Can't be near a child. Can't smoke near a dog. You can't fucking smoke near an old lady. It's crazy. They got crazy ass laws. You gotta have a cigarette and the cops will have on the top of your breaking damn neck. Cuddy is goldie. Cuddy, one of the greatest to ever touch the planet. As long as it doesn't break any regulation regarding smoking indoors, class should be outside anyways, but the weather kind of hurts. Imagine being a human, you know what I'm saying? Literally fueled by the sun, vitamin D, and all that shit, and being scared of the weather. It's the thuggish, ruggish mom. It's the thuggish, ruggish mom. She went hard with that. She went hard. Kayo. Motherfuckers out of school now. And hey, bro, dude, we gotta do what we gotta do. Damn. Stay in the motherfucking building, man. Happy fucking home. Fucking home on a daily basis. Imagine not fucking hoes, boys and girls. Hey, hear me now, hey, this time I'm ready for it. Can't stop this worrying me, can't stop this worrying me, me, me. Hey, yo, check this out, bro. I saw this shit earlier, bro. This shit was crazy. These niggas, the pastor and shit got hot with my boy, cause he ain't trying to get no money to the church, bro. Like, what's going on?
I'll stay in this position. Yeah. I'm getting into the position in front of my faith right now. Yeah.
Well, the elephant in the room is this, and that
elephant. Go to a weed smoker restaurant. Hell yeah. See, I go to that weed smoker restaurant. You already know I'm blowing that ass out. I'm blowing that all out. But that's the problem, though. See, like I said, man, I don't know if I'm getting old or whatever it is, but back in the day, I'd be like, hell yeah, weed smoker restaurant. Yeah, dude. Oh, totally. I mean, all I really need is smoke a blunt before I go in, or you know what I'm saying? Hit the card a few times. Do I really need to be that blasted while eating pancakes and chicken? Like, you know what I'm saying? I need to be getting blasted while, and I'm kind of one of those people too, like, while I'm smoking, I don't really like eating while I'm smoking, you know, like, I smoke, and then give me a second for the munchies to kick in, you know what I'm saying? First, it's going to be that dry mouth, I got to drink a little water, I got to drink a little some substance or something, and then that's that, or like, see, you can drink while I'm smoking, you can do that, because that offsets your dry mouth, and then you got to chill for a minute, let shit settle it there, I really start punching you in the chin, you know what I mean? And then you'll get hungry, and then you go eat. But you know what I'm saying? I ain't just trying to, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's just kind of weird, you know? But hey, you know, to each his own in that sense. To each his own. And like I said, a weed restaurant. See, you go to my weed restaurant, like I said, everything got weed in it, bitch. Everything. The drinks got weed in it, nigga. And I got Coca-Cola. I put the Coke back in it, too. But, you know what I'm saying? Put the cocaine back in Coca-Cola and my shit. It, like, they ain't never gonna test it. They think it's regular Coca-Cola. Goddamn it. Shit, I got Pablo and Escobar in the back, bro. Chopping this shit up. I'm going crazy in the motherfucking drink machine. Like, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, like, this is how it go, man. I'm trying to motherfucking do a big. Like, see the kid. Yeah, I dig. But yeah, alright. Thugger held it down. Gunna snitch. Hey, yo, real quick. With that whole gunna snitch shit, here's what I fucking think. You think Thug just over there, whoa, hurdy der, everybody stay hunkered down, guys, doodly-doo, everybody be stupid and come down with me, doodly-doo, I'm the only nigga they want, I'm the only nigga that they got true dirt on, doodly-doo, everybody go down with me, doodly-doo, yeah, I gotta pay all these lawyer bills and all this, and I ain't out making no music, doodly-doo-doo, I'm like, you think Thug a dumbass? Thug probably told them niggas, hey, look, this it for me. What I need y'all to do now here, because this is where the shit really, y'all talk about all that hoop-lotty-dotty. Thug was going down, whatever. Like, that shit is already, like, Thug, that boy ain't get up there and say, oh, yeah, Thug shot a nigga, Thug did this, Thug did that. He just said what he had to agree to get out of the situation, which is, yeah, they a gang. Yeah, this and that. Motherfuckers already know that. Why sell a gang? Niggas know that, like, niggas been knew, I knew that, niggas already knew that, for one, before it ever was a case, if you didn't know that, here's the thing, let me enlighten you, everybody know that shit a fucking gang, it's a gang, like, the bag been out there on that shit, and fucking, like, that nigga, look, put it this way, Thug gonna have to pay, like, a lot of lawyer bills, a lot of shit, he gotta keep a lot of shit going, he can't do that while he inside, hard to do that. You ask me, you want my personal opinion? I think Thug was definitely okay with Gunna having to do whatever he could do to get out of the situation. Because he could hit the studio and make more music. And guess what? Here's something else you got to think about now. And there's been times where niggas betrayed niggas, went by whatever. But like Gunna has said before, and you see it from his story. And you can even just see the way it's set up. That's why I think Thug had no problem and probably encouraged the nigga to go on ahead. Because Thugger brought that nigga up when he was broke and poor and dusty. He said that's one of the main reasons he brought him up. Because Gunner was so fucking dusty, he felt bad for him. He wanted to, you know what I'm saying, make something out of the kid. And he made a lot out of the kid. And Gunner has always said how he's so loyal and how he's so thankful for Thug doing that for him. So, and that's it. Like I said, niggas have, you know, been brought up by even better niggas, made millionaires, billionaires, and left those niggas in the dust. But I don't think that this is that situation. I think Gunna got out of it because even then, you gotta look at it. Gunna want no gangster boy. He want no gangster kid gangbanging, none of that. Even when he made music, his music won't gangbanging and really bust you up, shoot you up. He said some shoot you up lyrics here and there. But just about like everybody, even Kendrick done caught a few bodies in his lyrics. You know what I'm saying? Everybody raps a little bit about, oh, I'm bust you up, beat you up, all that shit. You know what I'm saying? But other than that, he ain't even no gangbanging that type of dude. He really just got suckered into all that shit because he started running with us. He probably was looking the other way the whole time. And yeah, that shit was going on. And he knew about it, but he didn't give a fuck because he tried to be down. It's the same thing, bro. If I were dusty and broke in the hood, which I damn near am, like a Thug came around talking about, yeah, partner, come run with me. And like, yeah, I may have a gang now. We may drop some niggas and shoot some niggas every now and then, but come run with me, you make millions of dollars. I'd be like, Thug, all I heard you say right there was you made millions of dollars. I didn't hear nothing else you said. You know what I'm saying? It's one of those things, bro. It don't mean I got a gang bang. It don't mean I got to do none of this. But I'm going to be around when it happens and I'm going to turn the other way. You know what I'm saying? Because he's trying to reap those benefits. So I think Thug looking at that same thing, like, bruh, Gunna really is just one of his artists at the end of the day. Y'all looking at it like they really runners together. Gunna wasn't having no gang runner, no gang banger, bruh. They were really just fucking, Gunna was that boy's artist. Like, so I heavily doubt that Thug has any issue with the way that things is going, because it's probably the way that they already accept it. You know what I mean? Talk about niggas talking about stay down and take you to trials. Everything. Man, y'all sound like some trial heads. Yeah. Y'all sound bogus, man. Y'all sound so bogus that don't make no damn sense.
I'm not finna come up here and give y'all all my money that I make every month. I'm just sorry. I've been foul.
But we're not looking for you.
You know, I put $20 a week. Yeah. And then sometimes I feel it. Good.
$20 a week is like giving a dollar.
What? That nigga says giving $20 a week is like giving a dollar. Like what? Did this pastor just say that, bro?
That's my business.
What world are we living in, man?
You get your 10%?
I wrote it down when you made it.
Look here. Let me.
I wrote it when you made it.
Well, she wrote what you make, and see, it does not.
Well, I just see, I got to define me. I'm not gonna let y'all attack me. I know robbery.
Just, I wrote that what you make. What the fuck?
You know, you ain't gonna rob me, and I'm agreeing to it.
Well, let's talk about robbery. In the book of Malachi, it talks about, will a man rob God? He said, yeah, ye have robbed me. You know. That's where robbery
happens. Man, let me tell you something. I really don't even believe in the 10%. Yeah. I'm going to just be honest with you. I think that was man-made. You feel me? Mm-hmm. Because back then, when they came up with 10%, ain't nobody had jobs. So where the money come up with 10%?
You said good snitch over here, the prince of family. Man, look. What gonna snitch on? I'm just asking. I ain't trying to be funny. What information they gonna offer up that's gonna be used against her? Y'all tell me what he said. Then he said, man, yeah, I saw Thug shoot this nigga behind the park. Oh, yeah, I saw Thug smoking a blunt. Yeah, I saw Thug pop a perk in his butthole. Like, what did he say? That's the only thing I see that Negro say was some shit he had to admit to, which damn near involved his black ass. Yeah, I know why I sell a gang. Yeah, I know the da 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 bullshit. Who the, like I said, at the end of the day, who the fuck don't know that? That's it. That's done. Motherfuckers really, y'all must be the same people that think YMW Melly getting out next week. Like, what the hell is wrong with you people? Like, Young Thug is in a different situation. He not in his home, comfy, all cozy, warm, cuddly, snuggled up with his iPhone and his laptop like y'all's is. Y'all can say anything. Oh, he a rat. Oh, he a rat. Oh, da, da, da. Thug is in prison, man. He has accepted a whole lot of things, bruh. You don't understand.
Duh! He confirmed that YSL was a duh! That's the problem. What's next? One of the henchmen of Osama bin Laden confirmed that Al Qaeda is a terrorist organization? What's next? Man, tell me what's next on the news. That is already was a thing. Hey, now I want you to tell me that you think there was a chance that Thug had to convince everybody that YSL wasn't a gang. Like, y'all gotta be slow. I've purchased YSL records, and I know that I've contributed to some gang violence. I stand by it. So much fun. It's a fire-ass album. But, I mean, come on. Like, let's be realistic with the shit here, man. Like I said, did y'all just find out that YSL was a label? Or there was a gang thing? Did y'all just find it out? That's all you tell me. Because over years, I was wondering, why the hell is this gang just operating out in the public? I asked that about a few other record labels. You know what I'm saying? This is out here, and it's like, bro, that's not a label. Like, we obviously see what it is. The hell you think you fooling? Like, only in hip-hop would they try that shit, and I see why. Because the fans act slow. I ain't gonna lie, y'all acting a little slow. Y'all just acting slow. Just acting. Y'all smarter than that. You acting slow, though. And that's why hip-hop would do it. It's like R. Kelly. That's why he'll run around fucking still dating little girls. Because hip-hop fans just act like they don't know what's going on. R&B fans. Like, huh? What? I ain't see no little girl. Who he pee on? Like, nigga, what? But yeah. It's one of those things, man. I said, some things you gotta accept, man. Like, you really gotta accept, man. Thug is accepting that shit. It's done. Like, what the fuck is they supposed to do? All sitting there look stupid and get, like, football numbers because they all want to sit here and act like nobody can't see what the hell they were doing. Motherfuckers just accepted that motherfucker, we got caught. It's a wrap. I done shot up 80,000 niggas. Gunner, you ain't really do shit. You need to get up out of here. Big bro, big head, doo-doo head. Y'all just sold a couple breaks. Y'all can bounce. Terry, you know you shot a couple of them niggas with me now. So, I don't know what we're going to do. But, you know we got, you know what I'm saying? Like, that nigga done got on the jail phone, bro. And done had to talk with every damn body in that bitch about what's going down, what they going to do, what they not going to do. Like, they a couple of steps ahead of us, I would think, on the internet and computers. Like, goddamn, we just all up in the situation. We all up in the Kool-Aid. Don't know no kind of flavor. So I'm trying to flavor what's on the TNK. Trying to shake you up, you die. Hey, man. You were talking here punk on this last album. Like, why can't you name the album punk? Like, what's next, man? What's next? You're like, come on, man. You can't, I don't think that's how it works. Like, what, 50 Cent and Get Rich or Die Trying? Like, he's a massacre. Like, it's just the name of the record. It's the name of the record, cuss! Name of that little beat on his album, I'm Gay, but then in parentheses, he said, I'm Happy. So, I mean, you can take that as you will. See, immature niggas, but he gay. They just said he happy. It's the other meaning for gay. And they're like, nah, gay. Gay. That's how it be though, man. So if I have her on the flippy in America, you can go to prison for 100 years on paper. God damn, -3 outside my house feel like a damn refrigerator truck. Hey man, I know your balls took the stomach. -3, that's nuts.
Who told you folk didn't have jobs?
Wait, what the job was? I'ma just be honest with you. I think that was man made. You feel me? Because back then when they came up with 10%, ain't nobody had jobs. So where the money come up with 10% at?
Who told you folk didn't have jobs?
What job was? Everybody paying everybody with apples and oranges and bananas.
They had jobs. They had livestock. They had
Black folks you know had livestock?
Livestock.
They had a half a pig with one leg.
Don't have to be black folks.
Half a pig with one leg.
All throughout
the ones that had sense.
You gotta pay them.
You probably had it.
She said you gotta pay them tithes. You gotta pay them tithes. This is church mafia.
I'm not going to go back and forth with you about some money because the church is well taken care of before you came. We're trying to allow you to be blessed because
we try to allow you to be blessed.
Giving my money away, Papa ain't going to bless me. Okay. You're not giving it away.
You're doing what God say do with it. You're not giving it away.
You got a chair and a desk in here, too?
I don't need nothing to tell you the truth.
Let me share with you what happens normally when people don't tithe. When people don't tithe, normally they'll end up being sick. They'll take it to the doctor. They'll take it to the dentist.
And that's why I tithe.
Because God is going to eventually get his.
That's own. Why I tithe.
Yeah.
He just said, if you don't tithe, you're going to get sick. That shit crazy.
Well, I bought the car from you.
Where? Is it still up?
Yeah, it's still up.
Okay.
But I'm just saying, it shouldn't break down. I bought it from you. Where? You once sold me the car.
You had to put a
part of all my life. Y'all know that, right?
Yeah, you had to buy a new tire for that car. Quit lying. You had to buy a new tire for that car, and you had to buy a part for that car.
I ain't talking about that, Malou.
What they talking about? Anyway, a car. Mm-hmm.
Somewhere. Car breakdown.
How we get to talk about
that's
a car?
That's why I tied.
Yeah.
You're going to get it some way.
Mm-hmm.
Somewhere. Car breakdown, hospital,
tire.
Well, I bought the car from you.
Where? Is it still up?
Yeah, it's still up.
Okay.
But I'm just saying, it shouldn't break down. I bought it from you. Where? You once sold me the car.
You had to put a part of all my life.
Y'all know that, right?
Yeah, you had to buy a new tire for that car. Quit lying now. You had to buy a new tire for that car, and you had to buy a part of that car.
I ain't talking about that, Melissa. Stay out of grown man. But you shouldn't even be in here talking about my money.
I put that money in there for you and me.
The part with me, the collection box, I'm sorry, but some had went in there that belonged to me. And it took everything in me not to go in that
box.
So
what you're saying, you just want to change.
Exactly. And everybody walking around acting like there's no change to be given. You know.
And then you can't get change out of the collection box. Man, what kind of shit is that? I remember niggas getting changed all the time. And look, now I know, bro. Back in, oh my God, you talking about a finesse that could have been pulled? Imagine you the nigga that's almost up there when the damn collection box get full, and you got old lady Sadie next to you and blind big brother Pat. They the ones next to you. They throwing big dollars in there, big bread sticks. Then they throwing a credit card wallet in that motherfucker. And then you go in there, you like you pulling out a big bill, you really dig that motherfucker in there, put it on the $100 bill, grab you some change real quick. Jesus Christ, man. I know some niggas in the 90s got grabbed, you know, going to church every Sunday, coming out with $1,000. Oh, Jesus. I don't know why the 90s, either. That sound like a 90s
so,
nigga scam.
You know, I just...
What?
I wanted my change.
You want me change?
I wanted my change, yes. I wasn't finna put no whole $100 in there. I ain't got but $100 left.
We don't get change back.
Here.
I know. We don't get
y'all
change.
Look like y'all don't get change.
Yeah, y'all don't get change.
Sonny Folaz, we don't get change. When you stick it in that box.
I didn't stick it in there.
Well, when your wife stuck it in there.
Well, that ain't my hand.
I feel like I got robbed. Right now, brother Terry.
Boy, I would have been going crazy in the church back in the 90s. Totally. I would have been cashing out on God, literally.
I've been listening to you talk to her all type of way. Don't do that no more. Do you going to have to speak to me, personal?
That's his sister.
See, folks, don't say that stuff you do at the house. You come to the
guard
house. At the house.
No, that's his
I'm going to be sitting up. It might be look like I'm sitting here doing jumping jacks or something.
Well,
ain't no current me. What you saying to me? That's your sister, but this is my wife, and I'm the man of mine. I pay the bills and mine. I hate we having this conversation in church.
In church.
But you brought it to my attention. You need to let me know when you pull up next time. At my house.
I put that money there for
you. You not need to say nothing else today.
Hey, to me, Terry. Now, I'm not going to listen at that. He a G.
Because you gave these folk my check stub.
You done gave these folk my check stub.
Y'all look alike, too.
Yeah, we do. We both do. And family.
You'll catch it later on.
Later on. I see we need to speak to each other on a personal thing.
Yeah. With white beaters on.
It is a family driving church. I don't know what kind of drama. Your TikTok's getting long AF, yo. That video was like 90 minutes long. That was a TikTok. They got the nerd to put a logo in it too. TikTok, wow, bro. TikTok need to get on about their business. I get so high. I get so high. Too low in my life, bitch. I gotta stay hella when I play both sides. I'm trying to hit it when I play both sides. Yeah, this is my favorite Kanye song in the world, yo. This shit don't make no sense. Niggas like, imagine having a favorite Kanye song. Bruh, hey, this shit lit.
As I lay me down to sleep, I hear her speak to me. Hello, Mari. How you doing? I think the storm and out of rain, the clouds are moving. I know you're happy, 'cause I can see it. So tell the voice inside your head to believe it. I talked to God about you. He said he sent you an angel. Look at all that he gave you. You asked for one and you got two. Mm-hmm. You know I never left you. 'Cause every road that leads to heaven's right beside you. And that's so I can say, hello, my
RP Juice. Hell yeah, man. Just like the there in a big smoke cloud, man.
On rising to the sky, I know your name. Hello, my only one. Remember,
this is a Slipknot Kanye track. If you ask me, bro. If you ask me.
Your mistakes. Hey, oh, the good outweighs the bad, even on your worst day. Remember, I'd say.
Hey, I said this song to you. I probably did.
Hold on. And if you knew how you would shed a tear, have a fear, no, you wouldn't do that. And no, I didn't pick the day to turn the page. I knew it, and then every time I see your face and I hear you say, hello, my only one.
He did not say remember who you are right there. He literally said and put lyrics to him. Has always been this yay, man. I don't know where y'all been at, man. That's a joke. Everybody take the point when they like Kanye's music and attribute that to him being some type of different Kanye, bro. That nigga always lit. He just made songs that you liked more. When Kanye making tracks that you like, he can do whatever he want, but since he's making shitty music right now, you know, ain't nobody trying to hear that.
Yeah. Remember who you are. No, you're not perfect, but you're not your mistake. Tell Marie about me. Tell Marie about me.
I just want to do this one thing.
Tell Marie about me. Tell Marie about me. Tell Marie about me. Tell Marie about me.
Tell Marie about me. Man, yeah, always been that real. I'm telling you, bro, niggas just only listen when it's some real shit that pertain to them, man. Kanye always just been that nigga. He always been that same exact dude. But he just, that's what people do, man. That was everybody corralled around Kanye when he said all this shit. When he saying some wild stuff. Where was all that corralled in? Could niggas be like, oh, what happened? What happened? Okay, so you said what happened. That mean there was a point in time when he was lit, when he was fired. All right, what was all that corralling in behind the shit he was saying? Like, I don't remember everybody corralling behind him. Like, oh, man, he just said something lit. He just said something insightful. I don't remember those times. I see at points when everybody corralling around him talking about, oh, why he do that to Taylor Swift? Or why he say this and that? I see that, though. That's what I'm saying, man. People are cap if you listen to them hard enough, man. People really say some captastic shit. Okay, yeah, I always been in there. So I'm trying to figure out where that time. There must be some time, some point where he's dying, man. 2006, man, or 2000. Like, it gotta be a point, man. What point is that?
Yeah, the truth, Yeezy 2024. You already know, bro. I'm gonna be rocking some merch. I need the merch. I'm gonna pick it up, man. Imagine not picking up some Ye merch. Imagine. I'm gonna pick it up. Funeral home struggles to keep up and COVID hit Beijing. Damn, they still hit. And they struggle to keep up. Damn. That's nuts. That's ball sacks. When the racks too skinny. The racks be too skinny all the time. I ain't gonna lie to you. This shit crazy. So little bro over here talking about Gunna Wanna.
So look, bro. My boy, my guy.
And look, you already know DJ Ghost about to be gangster about to watch Big. If that was me, man, I would have been a gangster. I would have been a G. I'm going to be 100 with you. I'm going to be a G.
30 hours after.
I'm going to be a gangster.
That Gunna, I mean 6ix9ine, I mean Gunna.
He's stupid. Got out of
jail, right?
Also, Chad said I still listen to that.
I don't know how he pulled that off.
You know
off,
what I'm saying? Kanye doesn't make good
by
music.
By him pulling it off.
Because of the stuff he said. He's scared to be a cancel. He still make fire, bro. He still make, but Kanye just a fire guy. They drop your game attack.
The police really have one. What I mean by his young
man, Xbox and PlayStation is the same as my Instagram. I ain't Larry Jones, but I don't even play on them anymore.
Boom, you caught up.
I play on Steam. I play on fucking PC, but I forgot my name. I think it's Crackers Our Food.
The county is disappointed. So, yeah. The DA is disappointed because you're getting off, or you're probably walking with it. You know what I'm saying? But this happened back in the day.
I think that's what it is. It's Crackers Are Foods on Steam.
So they probably
trying to. Because I ain't Larry Jones on PlayStation, Xbox, and Crackers Are Food on Steam.
They found a cell phone. When they find a cell phone, bro, and this way.
Crackers Are Food. Crackers ARE Food. Crackers Are Food.
I guess they find some incriminating stuff where Young Thug, everybody know he had honcho at YSL.
I check out Ye's and stuff. Like, why not?
Hey. I don't know who it is.
Yeah, one of the goats, man. Bad.
So when they get the cell phone, you gotta check like, I know it's something up in here, but I can't tell what it is, what's up in here. I'm just telling y'all what the cell phone said before the police actually opened it. They sent it off to somebody if they can't get it. So the whole time while they trying to get the phone open, Young Thug, Lori like, bro, this is some BS. Like, y'all go up here for this, and y'all find a cell phone. You don't know what's in the cell phone. The warrant wasn't for the cell phone. Y'all got to give us that cell phone back.
Mm.
Judge not being biased like judge shouldn't be biased.
Thugs got cell phones and shit.
Thug lawyer right.
Thugs got cell phones and cooking. Why you bitches in prison? Y'all think he give a fuck about one again now?
Listen to what I'm saying. Back then, when they got the cell phone, they couldn't crack it. For like a year or two and a half years, they couldn't crack it.
Damn.
So the judge said, y'all can't crack it, good, because y'all not supposed to be in it anyway. Get a phone back. They never get.
They try to be all up in my boy's phone.
So the people that they sent the phone.
They tried to get the unreleased Thugger tracks. We wanted too, bro. But damn. They're probably the ones who leaked half his music.
We got the phone open. It's some incriminating stuff up in here. You talking about offing people and whoopty whoop whoop and yada yada.
Oh, and that's another thing too. Y'all know a lot of Thug music got leaked too, right? I'm telling y'all, look, I'm just, you know, I'm bringing up my little bit of conspiracies and shit. A lot of Thug music got leaked recently, because a lot of niggas in Atlanta, Thug, Young Nudie, a lot of niggas' shit got leaked. It was, so they said someone, like, engineer at the studio or somebody, you know, that went rogue and started leaking shit. So that's another thing, too. Like, Thug just had a lot of, and Gunna, too, a lot of Gunna shit up there, too. But they just had a lot of music that came out that ain't going to be fresh no more when they put it out. And Thug gonna need a lot of music to, you know, keep, and especially a lot of new music to keep him paid, keep lawyers and all that shit, families and lifestyles and shit going while he's still locked up. So I'm telling you, man, I think that Gunna shit getting out. I think it's a lot more connected to Thug than y'all think. You know, y'all think Thug just like, oh no, why? Like, I don't think Thug that slow, man. Like, cause y'all understand this nigga a millionaire and all this shit. That gang shit and talking all that talk is cool and everything and fun while it's going on and you can do that while being a millionaire. But now, man, you gotta pick and choose. You think that nigga still out here just, oh, we hardcore to the brink gangster, y'all. We gonna take this all the way out. Man, man, what? Shit got real, bro. Shit is very real. And money being spent, and he ain't getting it back. When he was making that money, when he was out doing shows and doing features and all that, it's easy. Now he locked up. That shit ain't easy no more. So, like, I would put you on THCP. Oh, shit. And you have a 30-hour long half-life. Oh, God. I got to eat it at least 12 cats a day. Why not? I would have to be smoking carts. 4 carts at once. Oh, shit. I thought it would be vaped out. So, yeah, lucky. Dude, we are going to be growing weed together real soon. Hey, what's good, me homie Chris? I'm glad you fucking got some shit that's rocking for you, man. That THCP. Oh, shit. You know what I'm saying? Shit. How you living, though, man? It's been a long time no talking. Hope you're having a litty holiday. Said King Sign getting live.
Oh,
I don't know about all that. But, and see, that's another thing. Like, bro, he ain't getting no life. I don't know what kind of shit they working out. They doing right now. Fuck, ain't coming out with no crazy ass life and all that shit. That nigga may get motherfucking 10 years. I'm thinking some shit he gonna get. I'm no fucking judge, doctor, detective, none of all that shit, right? But just looking at how everything kind of going, that nigga probably gonna do like Bobby Shmurda and them boys did. He probably just gonna sit down for a good 8 years. You know what I'm saying? Probably it's probably gonna be some shit like 10 plus. Like sentenced to or whatever, but I think he'll be back on the scene around 2030. You know, it'd be one of the things, Thug, you know, 2030, like, Thug, we out 2030. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be one of those fucking things. So, you get out 2029, 2030, 2030, all that shit, get delayed a little bit. That be in the news, Thug, delay, release delay, all that, man. So, strap yourself in for that little ride, because that's what it's most likely going to be. You said racketeer is minimum 20 years. Hey, look. Hey, hold on, slow down for a second, because you telling me none of them get out within 20 years. Like, with all that fucking parole, good behavior, excuses. Damn, time served, man. Like, you don't do full time all the time. You just don't. I don't care what kind of case it is. You just don't do full time all the time.
That phone can't be losing evidence. So I don't care.
Racketeering. Who says he gets booked on the racketeering? You know what I'm saying? Like, just one of those things. He says he gets booked on that certain thing.
But I'm telling you, bro, it's shaking in his boots.
Come on. So people, I'm telling you,
Young Thug is shaking in his boots right now for the simple fact that his boy.
I don't know who's snitching.
Gunna.
That's the thing. Motherfucker say a nigga snitching. I don't know who's snitching. I really don't. I know Gunna. I don't know because I don't know what he said behind the curtains and shit. But as far as what we seen him say and all that and been fucking confirmed to say, nigga ain't snitched. What the fuck he say that was snitching? No. Look, motherfucker, like I said, like he said the only thing that the motherfucker could have said to get the motherfucker out and keep to get in the gallery. Look, this is y'all are leaving everything out but the money, man. Y'all are not thinking about any, like, y'all think that everything good with the money is just not a factor. Man, what? Come on, man. Like, consider for a second the fact that Gunna and Thug still, you know what I'm saying, cooling in cahoots at the end of the day. Like I said, Gunna won't never know gangster. So I don't think that if Thug is such a good-hearted guy like everybody claim he to be, I heavily doubt he's going to look to this man. Look, his biggest thing, like, and this is why Gunna going to take the stand and all this other shit. Gunna can get up there and literally say, I don't know, when they ask him about anything the fuck else. Like, come on, look. It's gonna Frank gonna testify at the plea agreement. But testify to what? You gotta testify to what you know, right? So, yeah, I can go and testify. But a motherfucker asked me some shit that I don't know. I don't know. That's the problem here. Yeah, he didn't say, is he confirmed to testify and tell everything confirmed? This is confirmed murder, confirmed coke, confirmed. He just said, I'm going to testify. Like, because that's what he had to agree to get out. Like, that's what he had to agree to. That's the thing. He didn't just say, I'm going to testify too. Like, he didn't just throw that in. Like, that's the problem. Like, I get it. I hear what you're saying. But that's the reality of it. Because that's what an agreement is. He made a damn agreement. I don't think Thug. Look, here's the thing. Y'all think that when they say, oh, blah, 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 gonna get agreement, la, da, da, when he heard the news, you think Thug was, oh, shocked to himself. That motherfucker already knew. He probably told that black ass boy to go ahead and fucking take an agreement. Cause what the fuck else is he gonna sit there for? Look, you want the worst part? Sitting there, make him actually fucking look like he did something. Like, it's sad to say. Sitting there like, yeah, I'm gonna take the trail. Y'all ain't got nothing on me. Like, cause look, he just straight up told him, hey, y'all ain't got nothing. Like, y'all ain't got nothing that I could agree to, so what the fuck? Like, yeah, I knew niggas was a gang. Yeah, I knew that. Because that's what the, that's it. That, on that gang shit, that's it. What the fuck you gonna sit there and fight that for? You look dumb. Thug gonna agree to it in a minute. Like, what you mean? Everybody about to agree to that shit, because it's in plain fucking right. It's in plain sight. Like, I don't know what else to tell you about that one. What's up, my dude? Hey, Big Andrew, how you living? Man, come on, man. That one's done. That was cooking on that one. Fighting murder and fighting all of that. Now you got something. But fighting, oh, we was a gang. That's done. Like, and plus a gang. What's a gang? You be a gang. Hey, that was criminal activity. What's a criminal activity? Downloading the song. You know what I'm saying? That's criminal. That's a crime. You do it enough times, that's activity. I mean, this is broad language, you know what I'm saying? That's how the law works. Unless your black ass saying this exactly, broad language is broad language, you know what I'm saying? Like, this defense thug was already having snitches in his circle, so it's his fault. Hey, man. Oh, everybody got snitches in his circle. There ain't no circle that ain't got snitches. That's how that work. You get enough people involved in anything, you get snitches. It's like, you get more than five people. Your snitch ratio is going up drastically, you know. You're acquiring a snitch ratio is just going through the roof.
Talk to you one head, my bad. Young Thug picks. Look at this.
Why Young Thug picks?
Look at this, bro. This is a perfect one. Right here in this picture, right here, bro. I said when they in the club, don't it look like they in the club? A strip club or something? I'm like, Gunna did not whisper in his ear. I said it on my last video. I could see if Gunna was at a club with Young Thug, he like, look, bro, I know we having all this fun, but whisper straight in his ear. If we get crack and hit the fan, I'm going to tell him, y'all niggas, bro.
He's stupid.
Know right now. You got some more ones? You can throw it out the strip? Yeah. Look what they doing. They look cool.
Man. I thought that he was rapping
some
shit,
though.
A fool
you was cool with, getting money with, slept in the same room with.
And like I said, man, look. Hey, man, look. Here's the problem, man. Why is there even no chance of almost damn near the obvious thing not even being a factor? You really don't think that one of the biggest breadwinners in the label that really ain't did nothing, you think they want him to sit down for what? I said, for what? Everybody's looking at this from such a fictional world. Y'all niggas be like, yeah, man, because you got to be gangster. Gunna ain't a gangster. He ain't even a gangster rapper. Why in the fuck did he need to sit down? He going to get out of this shit and go do songs with niggas on the Disney Channel and shit. And nigga, man, what y'all talking about?
Yeah, man, be a hood nigga. Got to be dude.
Hey, mom. Until Thug say, he might. Until Thug come out and be like, yeah, man, bitch ass nigga, I don't know why he did that shit, man. Shit on me. When Thug come out and say some shit like that, I'll be like, hey, you got a whole nother world. But I honestly, man, I don't think it's going down the way people think it's going down. Like, man, like Gunna just in there, like, sweating bullets and, Oh man,
what y'all wanna know? I'll tell you everything.
Like, some shit, like I said, it's like a movie in y'all here, man. It's a movie ass shit. These niggas, at some point in this timeline here, Thug and his motherfucking lawyers, all them folks sat down and said, alright, here's the chances of this shit going the way we wanted to go. Is it your black ass getting out of acting like nothing happened? This is the chances of what's really gonna go down. And they just started prepping for what's really gonna go down. That's why all this shit happening at the same time. All them niggas doing that shit, folding, growing, getting out, splitting out, dipping out. Cause they just trimming the motherfucking fat. It take a fuck a lot of money and a lot of resources to fight all them Negroes at once. All they doing is trimming the motherfucking fat. so they can goddamn focus on Thug. Go ahead and get Thug what they're gonna give him. And go ahead and let Thug serve it. He feel like he goddamn Gucci Mane. They'll chop up all the motherfucking Negroes anyway. So it's just gonna be the Free Thug campaign. Like, they already setting this shit up. They getting Free Thug shirts already printed up right now, bro. I'm telling you, like I said, it's just a couple steps ahead. Just a couple steps. I think it's gonna need y'all to still like Gunna, man, and support that, man. Cause now y'all make it look like he's playing backfire. I'm telling you, man. This is all in the Grandmaster plan to keep YSL going. I'm telling you, the worst part about this is the worst part. They're gonna keep the goddamn operation going. Somehow through this shit. Gunna gonna be getting money still, goddamn, keeping YSL on. And then he really gonna be involved. I'm telling y'all, man, y'all think it's a damn joke, man. I don't know what y'all think this is, but I'm trying to halfway tell you what that goddamn Zagat is, because it's right goddamn there. The hell kind of sense they make? These niggas need money, man. Money make the world go around. All that snitching bullshit y'all talking about, that shit free y'all talking about. That shit is free. Y'all gotta understand it. You gotta follow the money sometimes. Follow the money. What money do they get by gonna be in jail? Follow the money, man. It just follow the goddamn money. Bobby Shmurda and all the boys did that shit because they ain't had no money yet. So what the fuck with that? They ain't even know no lifestyle. Like, let them boys have lived that life for a year, a hot year. Boy, let hot nigga, boy, a hot year? Let nigga have been had a hot money for a hot year with a real hot nigga? Oh, boy. I'm telling you, bro. It would have been a snitch-a-thon in that motherfucker. Because niggas done got used to their money. And they got used to their bread. Them niggas was still in the hood trapping. They ain't give a fuck. They were, you know what I'm saying? That's how this shit went. You see how quick his label got up out of there. Like, if it was a situation where he was making bread on bread and his label stuck around because he was just getting so much chicken. Shit. So I don't know about that one. Shit, you better know. Better know quick. What are you talking about, the Bobby Shmurda shit? That would, you tell me what you don't know about them snitching. If they would have been accustomed to the bread by the time they got caught, you don't know how powerful that money is, man. Bro, I'm telling you, these niggas go from dusty, ashy, running through the streets, having to rob niggas, bro. Can't eat all the damn time. And then they go to buying cars, buying houses for their mom, dukes, and having girls, having... Man, that's some real serious shit, man. That shit was different. That shit way different. It's easy to run the streets and gangbang with your little nappy-headed homies when that's all you got. When you got a whole different world, boy, it's like I'm telling you, bro. Them niggas gonna sing like motherfucking choirs, man. Gonna sing like a choir. Show me one rich nigga. One rich nigga that did that shit. Held it down. Like, just held it down. Had a chance. Had a plenty of chance, but held it down. And I'm telling you, it's a hole in there somewhere. It was some niggas he just couldn't tell on. You know, some situation where he couldn't tell it get him into more shit. Like, it's all kind of shit going on, bro. All kind of shit, man. Like, this is how it go, man. Like I said, and I don't make the rules either. You think I made the rules? I don't make no motherfucking rules. I say that boy at 4 a.m. That's crazy. Final day at GHS, June 1999. So, look at the swag. He's swagging on him. Right, he juicing on him.
I'm filming right now. What do you got to say to me in the future, dude? Briggs, you know, you used to be the little guy who used to run funny, you know? And now you're just the big guy who runs funny. Why don't you go get everybody over here? Let me film. All right, okay, you want to film this? You can see me. Yeah, I'm going to film. Give me a
I got to start out like a documentary, like a movie. And the movie, I swear they always started out with the main character, like, holding the camera and shit, and, like, going around, yeah, this is cool shit, this is over here, or filming himself, like, putting it down and filming himself, and then, like, at some point, he meets somebody else, and they're like, oh, man, that's a litty camera, doodly doo doo doo, let me film, and then he ended up filming that whole movie. It was always, like, a fucking, like, found footage slash hand cam, like, handheld camera style movie trick. Nothing is a neat trick. Gives you a little personal take on the person behind the camera and showing how he's the leader of the group. And then, you know what I'm saying, just passing it on to somebody else. This is it. Everybody knew Goodwin was going to tell this Crossstopper shit. Oh, Lord. And then I said, they all stretch it back to some old shit. Talking about way back when that nigga was a kid. Look, in fact, look.
Yo, look. That should prove to y'all that this nigga won't never know gangsta. What gang has he repped?
So Thug can act surprised. So Walker, this is
Thug is not surprised. Thug most likely orchestrated it. Come on, man. What world are you living in? Like I said, at the end of the day, the boy actually don't know nothing. That's why y'all talk about, oh, he's snitching or this and that. Thug ain't worried about him snitching or saying nothing because Thug ain't involved Gunna in none of his gang shit. Come on, man. The only thing that Gunna and Thug did that were criminal was they got pulled over and they had dope in the car. And they both drug addicts, damn near, like, riding around geeking. You know what I'm saying? What kind of crime is that? You know what I'm saying? Like, Thug ain't never involved a boy in none of his gang shit. That's one of his... Oh, yeah, look at this. Thug is also a record executive. Damn near a fucking record label owner or whatever you like to call it. He is that. You know what I'm saying? He is that. You know what I'm saying? Along with gang leader and all the other shit alleged. You know what I'm saying? He is an actual record executive and nigga with multi-millions of sales. Like, he's legit in the music business. Gunna is his artist, bruh. That's his fucking artist. He picked that guy up from nothing and signed him. That's his artist. He ain't looking for that guy to now. Just because the law and the FBI or whatever all them throw Gunna in. And like I said, that's a tactic by them boys. Y'all just falling into their fucking tactic. Because that's their motherfucking tactic to throw everybody involved. That's why you throw your grandma and your uncle, your cousins and all that. Because they already know that you as the leader going to get them out of the way. Because you don't want them to go down for what, you know? Especially, and look, here's another thing. They ain't did nothing. So that's why you're not even worried when they get taken in. Like, oh, man, what grandma gonna say? Because, like, unless you were calling grandma, I was like, yeah, hit this nigga. I did this. Or, yeah, taking your grandma on hits and licks with you. Like, what can grandma say? It's just heat. You know, at the end of the day, they're trying to put heat on you. They're trying to put heat on your family. All that shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's all they try to do, bruh. That's literally all it is. So Thug know them niggas gonna walk. He gonna make sure they walk. Because they didn't do nothing to begin with. So, let's see. So, you're probably right, though. I never thought of it like that. I mean, I just, you know. Just trying to look at it the way that I see it, man. I'm trying to look at it the way I see it. You know, I look at it the way y'all see it, too. But it's, you know what I'm saying, that's some shit that... That look like the most logical thing at the end of the day. Because like I said, y'all, they kind of ignoring the fact that the nigga need money, man. So I don't know where he's dumb enough to have that nigga around. Thug can still be this case, though. Oh, no, that ain't happening. Look, I love Thug. I love him to life. But when you talk about beat the case, nah. But, like, it ain't going to be as bad as niggas think it's going to be. But they got him rolled in. That's the sad part about it. They got G rolled in. I want him to, I want justice to be served. Put it that way. Cause I can't be one of those guys just act like that because I love a nigga Mercy. Like, just do anything in the world. And everything's fine and dandy. Like, you know what I mean? I love it justice to be served at the end of the day. Keep it like that. But at the same time, like, you know what I'm saying? Thug, he ain't gonna get no life and all that other shit. I know that much. The only evidence they got left is that YSL is a gang. That phone's basically out the window. So, do they throw the murder convictions and all... I mean, the murder and all the other stuff out of the window? Do they throw that out? Because they got kind of a lot of shit on other than just the gang and shit, but... Yeah. And the way he's doing it. Because they got the whole murder and all that stuff evidence other ways. But even, you know, his lawyer was trying to get that thrown out too, but... Like, if I ain't hearing nobody getting thrown out yet, the whole the rental car shit, has that been thrown out? Let's see. Oh, ain't no. Oh, you said ignore that. CBD distillate is hydrogenated CBD oil that has said to have 100 times more binding affinity than regular CBD. Sheesh. So, Larry, we still rocking with Gunna. I mean, look, I'm rocking with Gunna as much as I was before. Before all of this stuff, which. You know what I'm saying? I like Gunna shit here and there. I ain't never been no big Gunna guy, you know? Yeah, I really don't. realistically, I don't like him. Yeah, I don't like his music, you know what I'm saying? But he does have some tracks that I can fuck with. But on the most hand, Gunna always been whack to me. And I said all that to say, come on now. Like, I'm not going to sit here and, like, hold this non-gangsta-ass nigga. Like, he ain't even gangsta in the raps. Like, you know what I'm saying? More or less trying to be gangsta in real. Like, this nigga ain't gangsta no damn where. Only thing with gangsta was, like, his big brother, his big cousin, whatever you like to call it, through his label, his boss, basically. His boss was a gangsta, and now he getting roped into being a gangsta. You know what I'm saying? That's like the nigga over there with the janitor at Death Row gonna get fucking sent up the road, too. Like, come on, bro. Like, the end of the day, these guys just didn't do anything, man. It didn't do anything, and Thug, no, and look, like I said, look, you gotta think about this, Thug is the boss, Thug, and I'm talking about gang and all that shit, he's the boss, he's the motherfucking art, the label boss and shit, so, you the boss, and one of your artists that brings in, your best-selling artist, your highest revenue moving, all that shit, he brings in the most money for you, out of all your artists that you got signed on your shit. And he's getting sent up the road and getting jammed all up, locked up behind some shit you were doing, and you know he ain't involved. Why would you let him stay in there? You most likely gonna get him out of there and get him back to make a chicken so you can keep on making your money, everybody keep on getting fed. That's most likely what you like to do, most likely. I don't know everything. It's most likely.
Good luck to you.
A distinguished career. He didn't smoke crack under the bridge. Nah, he didn't.
Here's the Miss Kelly Knight.
Hey, Miss Kelly Knight. Sheesh. 30-foot white girl. You know, she can tear up a barbecue sandwich. Sheesh, she fired too.
Hey, Kristen.
Hey, bro, it's the 90s, bro. It's like every girl will fire back in the 90s. What's going on here? They bad on a different degree. Them 2000s chicks can delete themselves. These chicks old as fuck now. And probably still bad. Sheesh! Yearbook's on my desk. Talk about they all look 25 plus. You look 30. They're running in their 40s now. These old people now. This shit wild. Oh shit. Bob Briggs. Who the fuck is Bob Briggs? These different people or something? No. Final day. Hey. I said, dirty for white women, they in the building.
Okay, here it goes. I'm turning off the camera now. Hey, coach.
This is the end of the 92-99. It's crazy. Yeah, this is the final day of GHS. June 1999. It's just nice watching shit from back in the day. Not like how 1999 is back in the day now, like, you know what I mean? Back in the day was damn near yesterday.
Hey, Brianna, give me one of those looks.
Give me one of those looks.
Hi, Briggs, we love you.
Oh, I appreciate that very much.
Hey. Hey, I look at y'all too, jeez. All the great basketball memories. She funny. She a Karen now. You can tell she a Karen mom. That's good, homie. I hope you're doing good. Hey, you already know glitched out.
Oh, yeah.
full special CBD to get the job done. You do enough, you know. Hell yeah. You ain't got to do the most, is it? Imagine giving one of these motherfuckers a damn boy. They be blowing out of the atmosphere. We've been watching this shit, man, because all these people talking, having a good time, and laughing. And they probably ain't seen these people since this day. Like, you can think about this is the last day a lot of those people saw each other, you know? A lot of them kept up with each other, you know, over time, over the summer. But then some of them got married, and then some of them, you know, had very long relationships and all that. You know what I'm saying? So, some are still friends to this day. It's crazy how life go, you know? They 40 with kids, now they kids going through this shit. That's what the real weed, imagine weed. What did he say? He said, watch out for the police, don't let them stab you, okay? You're one of the weird kids walk around saying silly stuff. Shelly. Hi. Hey, guess who's going there too? Yours truly. I'm going there too, shit. That's what you're doing. Oh, bro, that's like Matt. Yeah, look at Matt from the past. Oh, shit. It's like Matt when you literally real quick. Oh, I'm not gonna stop a little watch that. It's gonna be bad when you look at it real quick. Oh shit, man, what's going on? So it became only fan mom. That's crazy. But she got a nice neck. She got fire in there. I don't know if she's lit. Sheesh. That means a long time this video. That neck lit. Where neck go, yo? Here, Miss Sadie. I know she'll go in. Look at that neck, boy. Golly. Y'all understand? I told y'all that girl with a fire neck, bro. I think it's a joke, bro. A fire neck just on a different level. Little girl with a lit neck. Alright, alright. She got a wide neck. She got a crazy neck. I still hit though. You can't say. We're gangbangers. Oh shit. I be angry with gangbangers sometimes. Don't mean I be gangbanging. Oh. This nigga, man, he hanging out with gangbangers too. Look at this gang. This gang right here, he hang out with the gang. Plus they with the gang. Teacher with guilt status. Bro, you gave a boring ass fucking. They're not wise. It feels like walking to like fences and presentation that you're like. Everybody there kicking it.
I'm not is gold. Sexually soft and easily molded. I'm like, I gotta stand strong, doesn't like get bumped around. And then my plant was a sunflower. It's all tall and like keeps on growing. And the thing I wasn't was moss.
Gay. You got sunflowers and shit, right? Gay.
My animal here is a shrimp.
My animal's a shrimp.
How you guys doing?
Being bad in the 90s. What are you doing?
I'll have to edit that out. There's the man right
there. Hey, Bieber.
There's a girl behind him right there. Yeah.
Yeah, 25, please.
Take Miss Yusuf.
I will.
What happened to me?
We've done a lot.
What is he?
Hey, Vanessa. Go away.
Can
I No. Move to the right.
No. Should we turn down all our books?
Yeah, please.
Oh, wait. We can go turn down our books?
Yeah. Hey, Mike. Crix. Turn around. What's up, man?
He got shot. Jeez. Hey, graduation. Graduation day. Teachers, let me get out of here, man. Let's teach alone. It ain't easy to be a reason. Oh, so it's cool pressure. I'm going to make the Indian dude with the glasses you talking about, Matt. Built like a cartoon. Girl, y'all see. You were the teacher. She was. She was built like me.
Jennifer.
Girl, don't wave at me like that. I'm going to put my penis in here. A system of equations on the last day? This clip was to be out of order. This is supposed to be graduation. See, I should have been paying attention to days like that. I remember I was just in class just kicking it like... Everybody else taking notes and shit. I was looking around like, sheesh. Alright, bro. She really think that we got time for this, bro. Like, seriously. They hear all this like this, bro. She just got on here to go to church, bro.
What's up, YouTube? Yo, gang. Welcome Hi. Back to the channel. I told y'all, y'all gonna see some more of this Barrett. We are at our 100 yard range. I have her zeroed at 100. She can't get me two, but this is the most I can get right now.
We're gonna be shooting some. Shooting,
is it soda?
Soda.
Is it pop? Is it 2 liter? Is it a cold drink? We're gonna be shooting some sodas.
Hey, yo, look. I got some fucking, what you call it, some y'all are in though. What's my favorite cereal? Honey Bunches and Oats. That shit calling me, bro. I done had some of that, bro.
And we gonna bring,
you know how I had Family Box? Bro, I found something better than the Family Box. The Mega. Bro, I'm going crazy.
We gonna bring her out, and we gonna get to shooting. Water set up. We got some fruit punch pop. Let me know what it is, y'all. What y'all call it in y'all city? And a 50 BMG. Big time versus right here. Watermelons must be out of season, cause I can't find none. But we're gonna go up here, set up, so we can send them down range. Alright, so I also bought my M249. I'm gonna set that up and have me some fun with that, but that's not what this video is about. This video is about that Barrett 50 BMG. Just set this up right quick. Y'all remember, brass to the grass. She's not charged. And And if you're just now meeting her, let me formally introduce you to this beautiful beast right here. This is the Barrett 8250 BMG. Beautiful. With the night course. And I will show you
that's a big stupid ass gun.
Everybody is familiar with what that round looks like. But I'll show you that in a moment.
Damn, I thought you were being funny. She must be in the military. No. Woo. She must be fucking somebody in the military. That's how that go. Posted with the gang gang. Ming gang. Come on, bro. Nice.
Here we go. Getting set up. I'm taking you along every step of the way of this journey.
Shawty jiggling. She jiggling and wiggling. I'm a little like my was on. Okay, my shit in reach. She got too much ass. It's fake. See, the whole thing about not reaching. It's really kind of a myth. You know what I'm saying? They got to think about it when a chick bends over. No matter how much ass she got, her vagina's like under her ass, if that makes any sense. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, doing all right today?
Like, you ain't going, you ain't putting yet. Like, think about a chick. When you fuck a chick, you don't put your dick through her cheeks to get her pussy. You know what I'm saying? Her pussy's like right there. You know, her cheeks is like kind of above. You know what I mean? It's weird. I don't know how to explain it. Really, it's really hard to explain once you look at right at a pussy. Like, when a bitch bend over in front of you, you can easily explain it. It's like, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, so like I said,
that's
earlier,
why once you bend over, a lot of times her pussy's popping wide open. And she ain't really got to spread her cheeks to pop her pussy. You know, that's spreading her ass over.
100 yards. We will be shooting the Barrett. And just checking out the zero. I know Corey did a great job. But we are going to make sure and have some fun with it, pretty much.
Make sure.
Okay, if you're new to the channel.
She probably only like learned about this activity because they make an ass jiggle when she do it.
This is the round. We're preloaded. We got some extra boxes down here.
She's like, oh, yeah. Niggas like asses, niggas like guns. I make a lot of money doing that.
And in the distance, I don't know if you can see that or not, but we got some tiny...
Hey. She wow.
Nice picture.
When she gonna bust that motherfucker? She ridiculous, bro. She wanted to get everybody to lean down.
Make her hot.
Hey. It hot. Make her hot. She funny for that one. Hey. She funny. She is hilarious, bro. She ain't gonna hit me no more.
Oh my gosh. Here we go. Niggas are funny.
I wonder if I can see the most replay. I don't know.
That one.
Damn, I can't see it. Now sometimes they'll show you what the most replay part of the video is. I can't see the part of it. She's funny, man.
Oh my gosh. Okay, we got two down.
Oh, Lord, forgive me. Damn.
Missed that one. Let me get myself together. Oh, grass. Come up behind my glasses.
Bam. Hey, it's a pretty good shot. She really is shooting. She is somebody else screaming, but she's all the I'm totally looking at the gun.
Damn, I missed that.
Yeah, she can't focus either.
There you go.
Oh, man.
All the part is shooting,
huh? Look, man, well, all this other plot wasn't needed.
I'm going to go ahead and pull that back. Look at this mat.
I'm telling you, man, this is working crazier and crazier.
Some of this grass blowback. But we got them down.
Some of this grass blowback.
Okay, I don't think I did too bad. I had a couple misses, but that was just fine. But I know what I do want to do. I want to rearrange myself because that grass and
I might
that
go
dirt
pull
in my face
was
not the mat is full of it.
You gotta so do what you gotta do, man.
So that we can,
Anything lead your identity.
Start over. Now, we do have some more water and soda down there.
Some more water and soda down there. They're just shooting the shit out of all them beverages, man. Where the kids in Africa going to?
Yeah, this is not good.
Oh, they could have ate that soda and drank that water. Ate that water and drank that soda. My little pony, my little pony. My little pony, my little pony.
Seems like we're too high.
Gotta stay high, gotta stay high. 27-year-old girl caught with 26 pounds of cocaine. Damn.
And these are yours. It's a warning notice for the window tint and a ticket for the...
Okay.
For not having your license with you. Like I said, as long as you take your license to the clerk's office within 30 days,
okay,
it'll just be a $10 service.
Any reason why a canine would alert?
Is there any reason
that
canine
would alert to your vehicle? When you chill on a bit like that, we strap like a video game.
Yeah.
That's what he said. You're not a meth. You're not a meth or marijuana patient.
Any hemp products in the vehicle today?
Any hemp products in the building? Right. Man, they ask everything. Now, this nigga got flashcards. K9 ain't alert to shit.
We're gonna need to check it just to make sure there's nothing in there that shouldn't be. Okay. You're not under arrest. Okay. But
I got the AC on for you. Well, she's about here right now. Like, oh shit, bro. It's a wrap. Beep.
7:39.
Look at that face.
Hey, can you let Maria know to go for my kids? I just got pulled over. Me acaban de agarrar. Estoy en bush now. And I need to get to my kids. Estoy detenida. Yeah.
See? I'm like, I don't know what they think. Nobody can't speak Spanish. I'm like, what? I'm on the way back. They're checking everything. They haven't found it yet, but they will. I'm not under arrest yet, but they're checking everything. They're going to lose everything. Everything. Damn. I'm not going to get out of this one. They got it done. Yeah, see? Come on now. She already knew what that boy was.
Better. I don't know. Maybe you don't get because of the tents. They said the tents were too dark. And
I said, I don't speak a lot of Spanish, but she and no danger.
I don't know.
I know danger when I hear it.
Okay.
She said, yeah, man, gotta go get the keys. No. She said, that Chapo thought hustle right there. Everybody crowd around each other. I'm like piggies do snort, snort, snip, snip. They must have found some donuts back there. Seems like they had already found the coke, if that's the coke that they messing with back there. So, Alright, that's obviously the coke back there. Okay. So I got a question. Because they found the coke back there when they were around there fidgeting around. And they were like, oh shit, cocaine. Let's see what we're talking about here. Okay. Well, no. Yeah, okay. When bro first went back here, he's like, oh, guys, I got coke. Really? Oh, you got coke? Yeah, all right, got bricks on bricks on bricks. All right, shit. Then you got a lot of bricks, too. Then you got like 30, 40 bricks. So then they sat around for a second. Yeah, see, like, this is a joke. They sat around for a second. And then, look, they went back. It's like they went around. They corralled. They sat back for a second, talked about what they're going to do. Corralled around for a minute. And what's this? That they start doing a lot of... What's this hopping in the truck? A lot of them doing a lot of hopping in the truck. What's this guy doing on the floor? What they doing? What are they doing? What they doing? It's real easy right there. La, 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 la. Just toss a brick over and homie over there and get a brick and stuff in his shit. And keep it moving. Like, what happened right here now? Because they were all corralled around the truck a second ago. He's scratching his head like he ain't know what's going on. You see that camera? The same guy that was on the ground right there. They closed the door for whatever reason. Oh man, Kappa said if anybody gets in the thing while they close the door, oh bruh, they can get good stuff. And now you don't know what's going on in the backseat of the thing anymore. They get inside, acting like he doing something. He didn't do nothing then. What is he doing? Acting like he doing something. He ain't doing nothing. Boy, they robbing the shit out of them bricks. All the bricks, they stealing, bro. They stealing bricks right now, man. Bro, they are stealing bricks. Then they go back to the trunk. Then they go back to the trunk and corral again. Like, oh man, remember that coke we found like an hour ago? I think it's time for us to start collecting that. Man, they stole some of the coke right there, dude. What the fuck? Man, they stole cocaine. What the fuck? They stole coke, bro. You can't lie to me. Look, I'm gonna come with these little measly packs. I know you don't go on here. These are skinniest packs. If I were to switch it out with baby powder, they wouldn't mess so damn long. Hell yeah, we made a bust. They're gonna stack it up in a pyramid too, make it look bigger. Them niggas sneaky, bro. Make it look bigger when you stack it like that. I got to that came out. That was a lady. Big lady in the business.
This is what's going on. There's some items in the vehicle that we need to take a little bit closer look at.
Okay.
And we need to inspect the vehicle a little bit further.
Okay.
But we need to put the vehicle up on a lift in order to do that. So there's a wrecker headed over this way.
Okay.
And there's his business is just right up here at the next exit just north of us.
Okay.
48. So you're just gonna hang tight with me and we're gonna follow your vehicle.
Okay.
It's been about 4 months since you
You do the math on it?
Yeah.
If that's all, let's just say it's 9 kilos.
You do it by the gram, correct?
If that's all, let's just say it's 9 kilos. Well, how you just saying stuff?
You do it by the gram, correct?
Yeah, but I'm just saying if it's 2.2 pounds a kilo, yeah. That's how it works. 20 pounds.
Oh, wow. Yeah, it's true. I didn't think about that, man.
That's going to be the largest hot, cold, you name it. And as cold.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? So, this you couldn't, and I think there's more in there, so.
Yeah, no, with that headliner.
And pulled out.
Shit, you counting the 6-7 keys they stole?
I got arrested back in 2013,
yeah. That's those keys. And think about this, he robbed a drug dealer. What the drug dealer gonna say? What? I ain't had 32 keys. I know I had 38. Like, what he gonna say? They gonna take a fat line. Oh yeah, they going back to they getting snorting. They getting snorty with it. It Billy Bob snorting. I'm telling you. They got the keys. Boot and bottle and boot and bill. I know the judge on shooting some jips. I got the keys. See, motherfuckers think that shit a Future song, bro. I know the judge on shooting some chips. Like, you can't do that, bro. Can't do that. I'm gonna get some more cereal, bro.
Absolutely losing their minds over the most trivial nonsense imaginable. And we compiled those meltdowns for you. So you can know that no matter how stupid you are, it could always get worse. A lot going on here. This woman has accused this pharmacist of messing up her medications and then says she has 4 children with her uncle. And then she says the pharmacist just runs her mouth.
That's why you keep doing it.
She did it to me 12 times. You got what you wanted. Quit playing with my medications because I'm tired of it. You can't be mature and be a pharmacist, and maybe you shouldn't be working as a pharmacist. She's the guy I have children. I have four children with her uncle, so I know who she is. You were just apologizing to me the last time I was here because
you're not flirting with my uncle.
Just shut up.
I'm not. I'm just. I'm
just don't even talk to me because you are. Just don't. I ain't got nothing to say to you because all you do is run your mouth and laugh and joke and yeah, you do. Yes, you do. I know who you are. You're immature and you shouldn't be in the medical field. You take your personal problems and you bring them to somewhere you shouldn't.
In this video, this madman is accusing this guy of being a hacker. The man is an absolute sigma, and he handles it with the most calm demeanor we've ever seen under such a situation. A true man among Karens.
Tell me! Right, John! Okay.
Let me tell
it's
you.
Handled. He's a f***ing hacker! What are you
John,
doing here?
It's handled! John!
I'm a telecom worker.
What?
I work for telecom.
Yeah, I know all about you people!
Look.
It's
your company sucks.
Okay.
It's Canadian, and you break into networks. You're a hacker. You
rolling
piece of
with that fire from hell.
You piece of get out of here. Get out of our neighborhood.
She's giving her the ballistic to her
get
uncle.
Get out of here.
John.
Get out of here.
No,
I'm gonna punch you in the nose. Get out of here.
The hell are these people?
Stop it.
I'm not a hacker, sir.
He's had the cops called on him before. Enough! Don't get me in trouble here.
You better not be.
No, you can call the cops. I'm okay.
You better not be f***ing with my network. You better not f*** with my network.
With my network. What are you talking about?
I'm telling you now.
What the hell are you talking about?
Now. Sorry.
It sounds like old people.
The people at this store caught this guy stealing. The receipt policy does have its uses. He proceeds to be shamed and outed for being the piece of garbage that he is.
This is the last video. What I miss. Oh.
This woman has accused this pharmacist of messing up her medications and then says she has four children with her uncle. And then she says the pharmacist just runs her mouth.
That's why you keep doing it. She did it to me 12 times, you got what you wanted. Quit playing with my medications.
I'm talking her zannies, man. She tripping.
You can't be mature and be a pharmacist, and maybe you shouldn't be working as a pharmacist. She's the guy I have children. I have four children with her uncle, so I know who she
is. Okay. That's weird.
You were just apologizing to me the last time I was here because
you're not flirting with my uncle.
Just shut up.
I'm just don't even talk to me because you are.
I ain't got nothing to say to you because all you do is run your mouth and laugh and joke and yeah, you do. Yes, you do. I know who you are.
What?
You're immature and you shouldn't be in the medical field. You take your personal problems and you bring them to somewhere you shouldn't.
In this video, this madman is accusing this guy of being a hacker.
Is she not right?
The man is an absolute sigma, and he handles it with the most calm demeanor we've ever seen under such a situation. A true man among Karens.
Tell me!
John! Okay. Let me tell you.
It's handled!
He's a f***ing hacker! What are you doing here?
It's handled! John!
I'm a telecom worker.
What?
Listen to me!
Yeah, I know all about you people.
Look.
Your company sucks.
Okay.
It's Canadian, and you break into networks.
It's Canadian.
You're a hacker, you piece of shit.
Why are you mad at a hacker?
You piece of get out of here. Get out of our.
The hacker fucking a girl or something.
Get out of here.
John,
get out of here.
No,
I'm gonna punch you in the. No. Get out of here.
Stop it.
I'm not a hacker, sir.
Cops called on him before. Enough! You're gonna get me in trouble here.
You better not be.
They've been retarded.
I'm okay.
You better not be f***ing with my network.
Get in my car now. We're leaving. Get in my car. You better not with my network.
I mean, this is like a bunch of a neighborhood of a bunch of drunk people. Drunk, stupid people that be harassing the cable guy.
Sorry.
It's alright.
It's alright.
People at this store caught this guy stealing. The receipt policy does have its uses. He proceeds to be shamed and outed for being the piece of garbage that he is.
Thank you for letting me know that I almost stole money from people who are destroying the earth.
What?
What?
Man, come on, just take the loss.
Ed! Nah. I don't like you. I want it. Take you out.
That would be a very bad idea.
And you!
This is a movie.
You need to be
called. Hey, maybe there's a way to get out of grime. Like, you just act like you're crazy as hell.
Also making a very inappropriate comment. Yet she
maintains her innocence throughout. Thousands of Batman Joker shit.
Appreciate the conviction, but this woman is a carrot.
Excuse me, I'm not moving.
One, you need to wear a mask. It's a mandate now inside of our store. And we can refuse business.
Then let's call the police. I will wait here for you to call the police.
I'll wait for you to call the police. One of these people always wait for you to call the police.
I'm not being wrong.
Now you're trespassing. Thanks. So you're being actually.
So I'd like
to wait outside. I'd like inside of our business, and you need to wait outside for the police.
You need to let go, and I need to call the police. You can call the police.
I need the police to be called in. Why somebody punch on her damn nose, then have a call the police in? Like, it's them people that act like that who know because they protected. Like, that's the only way they act like that. And somebody with a stick on her damn jaw and get down, which won't feel protected then.
Oh, you call the police.
No, I'm not.
Excuse me.
Because some people need it. Some people need a good ass whooping.
I'm not doing anything.
Ma'am.
Nope.
Woman, get your black ass up out of there now before they be done beat you.
Please let go. You're assaulting me.
I'm not assaulting
you. Yes, you are.
I'm not.
Yes,
I'm not
you
assaulting.
Are.
Ma'am, please let this go.
Nope.
Can you let this go?
Nope.
I'd like you to call the law enforcement.
I am. It seems like you got a medical
condition. Bitch, I am law enforcement.
You have a medical condition. Something's going on with you. Are you
I
okay?
I have every right to be here.
No, ma'am. You're
not. Oh, God. Lady, get out of there.
I'd like you to call law enforcement. Yeah, I'd like you to call law enforcement.
I will. Will you let this go?
Great. Nope.
May you please let this go, ma'am?
No, I will not.
Ma'am, may you please let this go?
I'm not letting
you're being
actually. And I'd like
ma'am,
to be accommodated.
I'd like to be accommodated. She doesn't even know what the hell she's talking about.
Ma'am, may you please let this go?
Please call the police.
Ma'am, please let this go.
Please call the police.
Please. You can smile. You can go. You're not wearing a mask.
Call the police.
They asked you to leave.
I'm not leaving until you call the police.
Ma'am, please let it go.
Nope. I'm going to talk to law enforcement.
You can talk to them outside.
Outside.
Nope. You're being asked to leave.
To go against you at the moment. You are trespassing on our property. The Safeway property.
You can kick
your ass outside and wait. We'll call the cops right there.
Let's go, ma'am.
You can call. I'm not leaving. I have every right to be here.
Ma'am.
Why are
you
hugging? Nope.
I'm a San Francisco native. I have every right to be
here. San Francisco native. San Francisco native.
You are literally assaulting me. Now I'm going to make a police report.
I am not assaulting you.
Call police.
Nah, San Francisco. Whoop that bitch ass, man. I be done whooped her. It couldn't be me.
Of handling the situation. And the customers.
Oh, why I just tell you about get your black ass on out here now? Damn. Black ass white woman can't stand you. That'd be a woman.
No, this is a public property. Come on.
This
man.
Is my place of business, so give me your card so I can refund.
All right, look. You about to give my cheese back. Give my cheese back.
Man, what are you, a rat? Give my cheese back.
You want this money back because you can't wait?
Because I have a place.
You went up at 3 o'clock yesterday and they're already.
Okay, but they. Okay, but nobody called me and informed me to let me know. I had to come back up here myself.
Where's the party trying to get?
I was just trying to get my Ford Fusion bumper. That's all I want. I just need my bumper for my car. And it's taking this long. And it's taking this long.
What? So, what year is it about? There you go.
2011. Like, it's taking this long. I understand y'all busy.
We have the parts. I mean, it is what it is. Nobody can expect to just come in here and just get a part right now. I mean, we're...
I didn't say it was off
and ready. We didn't say it was off and ready.
Okay.
I will get a pull for you as quick as I can. I don't care what you say. Stop talking to me, please.
Ooh!
Get a Just bear with me. I'll knock off a couple bucks and get it done right now for you.
All right. Thank you. Thank you.
I don't care what they have to do.
Thank you.
I was telling him that.
Thank
you. I was explaining that to him.
Just don't argue, please. It's okay. I'll take care of it. Here, I'll go home. I'll see you later.
Thank you. This is ridiculous. You're putting this on. Man, my fans, y'all, they tripping in here, man.
My fans.
YouTube.
I ain't walking to, imagine being in a place to do to talk about my fans. Oh, Lord, her fat lazy ass.
Straight right there. How you feel about this, man?
So what do you do when a crazy woman damages your property out of nowhere? She then claims that she's married to this guy's cousin, and then proceeds to not know the cousin's name.
And she was hot. That's what I was telling him. I remember arguing him in the beginning of the day, and they were arguing like a married couple. Dude just came in and said, what you need? And he looked right down, fatty. He looked slow. He ain't never heard of that bumper.
No sense.
Look, you better get my cheese back. This is my place of business.
Situation. And the customer still manages to come away from the altercation feeling like he's been wrong.
Say it again.
Do not record me. You don't have my permission.
No, this is a public property.
Hold on. Okay, man.
From the altercation. Pretty good job.
Touching me, and I'm not comfortable with that. Please let go of me.
The manager in this situation does a pretty good job of handling the situation. And the customer still manages to come away from the altercation feeling like he's been wrong.
Say it again.
Is that all he got from that video? Did we watch different videos? Like, he got in the whole spat with the bitch. When dude said he'll make it right, he was cool with him. But he and that bitch got a thing. What is he talking about? Maybe it's because he's...
No, this is a public property. Come on,
this
man.
This is my place of business. Man,
my place of business. All right,
look. You better get my cheese back.
Get my cheese back.
This just don't make no sense.
Okay, but
nobody called me and informed me to let me know. I had to come back up here myself. I was just trying to get my four fuser bumper. That's all I want. I just need my bumper for my car. And it's taking this long. And it's taking this long. I was just trying to get my four fuser
bumper. Ford Fusion bumper is inaudible.
Bumper, that's all I
want. Yeah, I'm saying here.
For my car. And it's taking this long.
Play that Joe Jones. Shit, which one?
2011.
He said 2011. Shit.
Like, why is it taking this long? I understand y'all.
We have other parts. I mean, it is what it is. Nobody can expect to just come in here and just get a part right now. I mean,
I didn't say it was
off and ready. We didn't tell you it was off and ready. Okay. I will get a pull for you as quick as I can. I don't care what you say. Stop talking to me, please. We'll get it pulled.
He's rocking with the owner.
All right, thank you. Thank you.
I don't care what they have to do.
Thank you.
I was telling him that.
Thank
you. I was explaining that to him.
Just don't argue, please. It's okay. I'll take care of it.
See, she's still mad. Like, why she so mad when dude just said, don't worry, I'll take care of it. And then she be, you know, kind of cool with Alfred there. She just mad. Like,
it's okay,
she hot.
This is ridiculous.
She said, go home, dude.
Man, my fans, y'all, they tripping in here, man. What's going on YouTube?
See, he talking about her with all the damn wonky attitude shit. He's talking to customers that walk around like he's wrong. Yeah, hey, what this dude?
How you feel about
this? He the manager.
When a crazy woman damages your property out of nowhere. She then claims that she's married to this guy's cousin, and then proceeds to not know the cousin's name. We hope she got detained.
This lady, she's walking down the street.
She a G.
Over here, stolen from Walmart.
How you know it's stolen? She probably bought that shit.
My tree, walking around my property,
she broke the tree.
Claiming it's not hers. Well, I'm taking this off of my property and putting it across the street. But yeah, she's done walked down here. She's got taken my tree off. She's broken it. Because I didn't break this. This wasn't broken. This has been cut. Look at that. You can see the slice marks. This has been cut. Somebody cut my tree.
Well, she cut your
Did
tree.
Did you cut my tree?
These people gonna hear the conversation.
It's been cut. There's a saw in your car. My tree has been cut.
998-8 is what I'm talking about. We coming on up.
Who the hell do you think you are? This is my property. I'm calling the police. I'm calling the police. I've got this on camera. I've got you on camera. I've got. Look, there's evidence. You've got that saw in there, and I've got these saw marks right here on this tree. What makes you think this is not my property?
Well, I'm not going to argue with you.
Well, I'd like for you to explain yourself. Why did you come over to my yard and cut my tree? What are you doing?
All right, I'll call the police.
Stay off my property. I don't ever want to see you over here again. I don't. It is. I don't pay rent. I own it.
Oh, you don't pay rent?
No, I don't. We own this. This is our property.
So you don't pay rent?
You don't own it.
She thought she had.
This is mine. I don't even know who you are. No. Who are you? State your name for the camera. Yeah, you're being recorded. You've been recorded this whole time. My cousin? I don't pay rent. I own this property, lady. You're crazy. What cousin? What's my cousin's name? You don't. You're married to my cousin, but you don't know his name? You just told me you were married to my cousin. Yeah, okay. And what's his name? What's my cousin's name? You're married to him, right? I don't have family anywhere near here. I see you up and down the road every day. Stay on your medication and stay off of my property.
This patient was half an hour late for his appointment and then started to become aggressive when he was refused service. The employee with the mask on deals with it very calmly.
Why you want me to leave?
And you are not going to have any. We call the police immediately.
Yes. Why would you want me to leave?
Because you are aggressive and you are making
fun. Why are you touching me? Don't touch me, please.
You are 25 minutes late, and that just works the way that we've got other patients. We can't take you today.
So I asked her politely. I asked her politely.
And she politely gave you another appointment.
No, she's giving me in July.
Yes, in July.
She's giving me in July. Look here.
I'm very sorry, but you are going to have to leave. When Hanley asked you to leave, this is a private.
But why she's touching me? She's touching me here.
Because you are being very aggressive towards
her. I'm not trying to be aggressive. I'm trying to be reasonable with her.
We understand that it's really, really frustrating when you've got something you want looked at, but you had an appointment and you were 25 minutes late. We can't.
But she's touching me. This is not the way to do it. Don't touch other customers.
But can you please?
If I'm being difficult, don't touch other customers. Please.
Leave my clinic immediately.
This is going on YouTube and Facebook. Be careful.
We are calling the police now.
Be careful. This is going to be on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram.
You can't use our faces like that.
It's going to be very problematic for you. You realize that? Your very rude behavior.
No,
I'm going to complain to the ministry as well. Ministry
the
of Health.
Being rude. You need to leave. Please.
I'm going to complain to the Ministry of Health and see
you
what's happening.
You're welcome to do that.
Hertz car employees were being disrespectful to his girlfriend. He did not take kindly to that. Both parties are overreacting in this scenario. Talking nicely would solve half the world's problems.
Because why? Because you don't have to. So your name is Wick.
You don't need to feel me.
No, your name is Wick. Because y'all just told me correct Wick. Y'all told my girlfriend that she needs to hurry up, correct?
She needs to
because y'all are offering me weird service. You just asked me to get out because I'm speaking to y'all professional about talking to my girl with respect. Ain't nobody gonna disrespect my girlfriend and then act like I'm not gonna shake up about it. I mean, y'all can call State Farm. That's what you should have did a long time ago, but y'all not gonna disrespect my girlfriend and y'all not gonna ask me to step out because y'all don't wanna do y'all job. Is that understandable? Is that understandable?
I'm asking you to leave.
I don't care what you're asking for. You're asking me to leave because I professionally, I told you, I've been professional, I've been cool. But you're not gonna kick me out and talk to my girlfriend any type of way. That's one thing I do not do. Y'all unprofessional. Just because y'all ready to go, that does not mean that y'all rush the customer up out of here. It's not no please because don't try to please her now because y'all were just talking to her like she a dog. She's a customer. She rent a car from y'all. Y'all give her respect the same way y'all give anybody else respect. Right to refuse. 3 o'clock or 2 o'clock, dog.
Here you going
out. I've been cool. But y'all not gonna ask me to step out because I stepped up for my lady. Okay, what's your name?
I already got their name,
Oh, okay. Y'all, sir, you with the black shirt, you wasn't even checking with her, correct? You were on the phone, you were doing everything else, right? Thank you.
Imagine getting hit from behind while riding a bike and then being harassed. This woman is categorically insane.
No,
get
I don't
my face. You hit me. You literally hit me. Pulled she out of the side of the road and you hit me. Get out of my face. Leave me alone.
No.
The police are coming. Just get out of my face.
I don't care. You know who I am.
Jesus Christ. Yes, please. Like, she's on my face. Like, get out of here.
Because he's telling me not to. I wouldn't be in his face if he wasn't telling me not to.
You think this is funny?
Yeah, I do.
I really hope you think this is funny.
I do.
All right.
There's no harm to your bike.
You're going to stand right here. You're going to stand right here.
Good.
All right. Good. I'm waiting for a pass before.
I am too.
You didn't see what happened, did you?
I did not, no.
That's fine.
I did. I was right
there. Yeah, you f-ing cut me off. You pulled right out of the side.
Cut
you were
me off.
All right, so you were not just parked right there as
Does
I was coming
Does it matter?
Down the...
I didn't hit you.
Oh, so she agrees. Okay, so she just acknowledged
not...
the fact that she was parked
yes!
and pulled out in front of me.
But there was no harm, and I looked to my right
that
and you were
no
there.
That makes no sense. There was, you weren't following the street laws. You didn't even bother to stop as I was pulling out. You kept driving.
I did too.
After you hit my bike from the back.
Oh, you see.
And on top of that, I'm on a
bike.
You're in a car. I'm in a bike.
So pay more attention.
Oh, so now I gotta pay more attention to people like you.
So I would pay more attention.
I need the police to get here so I can get out of here. I don't want to be here anymore.
Well, go.
I'm not going nowhere. No, I already called the police.
Well,
they already got my information.
When they get here, I'll tell them you ran away.
What? I'll be right here, bitch.
This guy accidentally bumped the canopy, and this woman wants his license and insurance information, even though he caused no damage. This other customer stands in for him in his defense, and this manager loses her mind over it.
Oh, he accidentally bumped your canopy right there. He didn't injure anything. We're wonderful. Winona, we're not trying to get you in trouble. Why don't you back the f*** off? Let him go. Okay? He didn't do any damage. Okay, Winona, what did he do?
He hit my canopy and he was trying to drive off.
Oh, he wasn't trying to drive off. He was trying to get some breakfast.
Thank you.
Okay? I'm not minding my business. I'm trying to get some food. Now you mind your business.
Quiet now.
All right, so we're going viral at White Castle. Is that what we're doing right now? Now I got your back, man. You didn't do no damage. Well, he moved it. Did he break it? No.
Oh,
I sat there and watched it.
He said what? He's fooling.
And who's your regional manager, ma'am?
These folks are cheaper rating, bro. What the fuck going on in this world, bro? Man, none of these people should be in any
position of
power.
Sir, are you
going to
report the damage? I got it on record. Oh, really? Is it damaged?
Yes, it is.
Really?
You don't know until it gets inspected.
Because it looks like a piece of to me.
Mm.
Oh, I got a lot of money, honey. That's why I'm driving this car and you're working at White Castle.
Alright,
so don't tell me I ain't got no wife. You ain't got no wife coming out here bugging him over him trying to get some breakfast.
White Castle, you talking about, thank you, my man. Your dad went on.
How about you hit the canopy on my building?
What did it tell us? I got you turning around. It's like that. You don't come out and talk like you went insurance and hit the canopy on the restaurant. You shouldn't be.
Why are you getting mad at something you don't even own, ma'am?
This is my store.
I understand it's your store, but you know what? He didn't do any long-standing damage, okay? He didn't do... He accidentally bumped it. He didn't try to drive off. He tried to fix it. Now, we can go ahead and let this go. You let him drive off. Or...
I'll call the police. Don't worry about it.
wasting time.
Hey, you want to take down my number in case the police come?
This guy decides to skip the line and then thinks that he's somehow entitled to it. The locals are rightfully annoyed at this and promptly call the cops on him.
You don't know the rules of the game.
Let's go. Please, bring the police down here. Please.
Get over yourselves.
Yes, call my son-in-law, will you?
Yep.
Get over yourselves.
Call my son-in-law over here.
Hey.
What the f*** are these people doing? Look at these people.
Look, take your picture.
I'm taking video. I'm putting this on YouTube.
Go for it.
I'm putting this on YouTube.
Please, so others understand, we don't fuck around.
Don't fuck around.
Yeah. What are your names again? Go ahead, tell
me. The asshole around.
What are your names? What are your names?
Why would I give it to you?
Come on, be on video. Tell me your names. What's the problem?
Put your name on there.
Randy Weaver.
You're the one doing
What's
it?
The problem? Keep it up. Go ahead. Go ahead. What the f*** did I do?
Okay.
I parked here. I parked here. Who the f*** are you before you? Get over yourself. Shut the f*** up.
So call the cops.
This is going on YouTube.
And I'm blocking up the boat landing so that you can... Get your ticket.
Giddy the fuck up.
Mm-hmm.
Get your
out of
call
my way. Right.
Call him.
You will.
Mm-hmm. What did
Where
I do again?
From?
What did I do again?
Where are you from anyway?
What did I do?
Where are you
What's
from?
The problem here?
You were a local. You
didn't wait
What's
in line
the problem?
Like everybody else is
the
waiting
problem
in line
is
to come to load their boat down
up there
here.
Said,
I'm waiting in line.
Oh, he doesn't wait in
you
line.
You wait behind the people coming
line.
Down.
I parked down here. What's the problem?
Where are you from?
I'm still waiting too. I live
I
in town.
You
get over yourself.
Sure.
Get over.
Okay. Be quiet. Be quiet.
Are you 35?
Look at her. Look at her.
Have you paid for this?
Did you pay for it?
It is not booked until June 1st.
Okay,
sir.
Karen.
So there is no right for you to be here.
Okay, Karen.
I am not Karen.
Oh
there
no.
Is no
okay.
Right for you to be here.
Okay. Okay.
Disrespectful. Go to your own slot or...
Okay, who is this person?
Totally understand that you're so...
Okay.
Get in your...
Okay. Be quiet, be quiet, be quiet. Just be quiet. Just be quiet.
Who are your boat in your own slot? You wanna...
Okay, we got you. What else do you want?
You know what?
We're being really nice to you.
You...
They know where...
being really nice. You screamed at my daughter.
I screamed at her.
Be quiet.
Yeah. Yeah.
So who's screaming?
Yeah,
really?
Get the f- away from us! You are not respecting our boundaries.
We got 6 feet here.
You're not 6 feet from our
listen,
boat. Get away!
Listen, Ashley,
okay.
Talking. On Mother's Day.
Oh yeah.
A boat.
Oh. Okay. What's the problem?
Get the f- off of our dock.
Oh really? Your dock? Why are you like that?
Because on Mother's
we're being so nice to you.
Not. This is not your mooring. You paid to moor your boat here. There would be no issue, sir.
Yeah.
This boat is
yeah.
Not mooring. Stop. What number? This is 35.
Really?
Just go to your
yes.
Mooring.
So what's the problem with 35?
That you do not book this lot. Get away.
So what if I have 35? Don't hit. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Just don't touch me. Don't touch me. So, what is the problem here?
You need to leave.
Be quiet.
Both of you.
Be quiet. Just be quiet. She's.
Leave.
Can you tell me what your name is and which
what
your
claim
is?
No, I wouldn't. Who are you?
My name is Richard M. Trump. What is your name?
I don't give a. About what my name is. I don't have to give my...
In this video, this woman thinks she can bully this guy into doing what she wants. Unfortunately, she messed with the wrong dude on the wrong day. He gives her a calm and cool verbal smackdown.
You not gonna change my voice, sir? Yeah, so shut the f*** up. Shut the f*** up.
Because you're a child,
shut
man.
The f*** up. I'm 32,
bitch. And I'm 22.
And I'm gonna keep talking to her. And you stay your ass over here. And make me.
I'm not going to. I asked you.
It is 9:53, by the way.
And I'm not.
9:53 at night.
See, you lowered your voice. Now we can talk.
I don't got to talk to you.
Yeah, you're talking amongst us.
No, I'm talking to her.
seemed intoxicated.
Who the f*** is you? Who are you? Call the police like you said you was gonna do.
I'm not going to shut up because I don't have to. You've been asked to leave by several store employees and the security.
It is 9:56 at this time.
What you think that's going to do? What they going to do?
You're going to get banned from the store.
So what? So?
That's just this what's getting bills.
Where you stay at? A one-bedroom apartment?
Actually, I own my own house.
Oh, I do too.
Okay.
I don't know about any of this.
That's impressive.
So what else you want to talk about? Right. Stop talking. Stop talking.
Shut the
up talking to me. You're too close to me.
You're the one that won't leave the store. So if anybody's too close to you,
I was talking to your manager, not you.
It doesn't matter. You were speaking incorrectly to my manager.
So what? Who the f*** is you? Her bodyguard?
Employee.
You her
matter who I am?
Is you her bodyguard?
Doesn't matter.
And what are you going to do?
What I'm doing right now.
Shut the f*** up.
No.
And I'm not even. Let's keep talking to
them.
Let's keep talking to the police.
Go right ahead. And they're just going to...
What are you talking about? Yeah, and I'm going to leave it then. Now. And look at your dirty... You got holes in your shoes.
Hey, you're damn straight. Because my
you
shoes don't matter.
You got holes in your shoes.
My shoes don't matter. My
you
shoes
got
protect
holes
my
in
feet.
Your shoes. Look at you.
Look at your face. Look at your face.
In this video, this madman is accusing this guy of being a hacker. The man is an absolute sigma, and he handles it with the most calm demeanor we've ever seen under such a situation. A true man among Karens.
Tell me!
Right,
Don!
Okay. Let me tell you.
It's handled!
He's a f***ing hacker! What are you
Don,
doing here?
It's handled! Don!
I'm a telecom worker.
What?
I work for telecom.
Yeah, I know all about you people!
Look.
It's your company sucks.
Okay.
It's Canadian, and you break into networks. You're a f***ing hacker. You piece of shit. You of get out of here. Get out of our neighborhood.
Do you want to get him?
Get out of here.
John.
Get out of here.
No.
I'm going to punch you in the f***ing nose. Get out of here.
He's mapping out the poles for faster internet. Stop it. I'm not a hacker, sir.
He's had the cops called on him before. Enough! You're gonna get me in trouble here.
You better not be. No, you can call the cops. I'm okay.
You better not be f***ing with my
network. Get him a car. Get him a car now. We're gonna leave it. Get him a car.
You better not f*** with my network.
All right.
Get in the car. I'm telling you now.
Get in the car.
Now. Sorry.
It's all right.
We've all come across at least one Karen in our lives, and while there's nothing more annoying, we must say that seeing them get back the same energy they give out has that sweet taste of poetic justice. To that end, we put together some instances of Karens getting what they deserve. This woman absolutely loses her mind at her boyfriend. We don't fully know why, but we do know this woman is an absolute psychopath. A security guard at an apartment complex thinks he can boss these residents around. Luckily for us, they proceed to give him the absolute business.
Speeding, dude. Does the company you work for know that you drive their car like that?
I have several people being uncooperative at the E. Edward building.
You're being audio and video recorded, just so you know.
Yeah.
You need to go inside your apartment. I'm giving you a lawful command. Go inside your apartment.
Oh, so you're police?
Security for the property.
Security.
You're security over there.
No, I'm security for this property.
I never seen you.
Because we have a partnership with them as well.
Since when?
That's none of your business.
Actually, it is because I live here, so it is part of my business.
Charles 1, I'll take a supervisor. We're through here all the time.
No, you're not.
I'm here. Yeah, we are.
No, you're not. I'm up from 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
You might drive, roll your cars over here, but you ain't never seen me.
I've never seen a single patrol car.
And there's a reason for that, because you got the wrong. Because I obey the law.
You're not obeying your lease right now. We don't allow people to loiter in the parking lot.
So am I not allowed to walk through my parking lot? What's
you can
car?
Leave and go and come back. You cannot hang out in the parking lot.
You don't know what I was doing. I could have walked right through that.
You were hanging around the fence. I had observation.
Uh-huh. And? Is that illegal?
You cannot hang through the fence.
Actually, until she's given a trespass warning, you can't do.
That's not true.
Yes, yes actually it is.
No, it is.
Yes, it is.
Read your
laws.
Are you
a
cop? No, yes, it is. You're not a cop.
Charles 1, start me at code 5. E. Edward 116 is the offender unit.
Give it 120. 2.
I know you didn't just do that. That's actually illegal because you haven't even given us a warning.
I told you to go inside your apartment, hang out on your patio. This is a common area.
This is considered a patio.
No, it isn't.
You look at the building.
It is a common area.
Shut the up and let me finish speaking.
Do you want to go to jail for disorderly conduct?
You know what? You can't because I'm pregnant. That's actually just a law because of law.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
Are you on the lease?
No.
She's my guest, you idiot. And you're treating my guest like.
Well, I'm going to trespass your guest. And that
no,
is my lawful
not.
Right.
No, you're not.
Yeah, I am. She needs to go inside the apartment or she's going to jail. This is your final warning.
Then you could
warning.
Arrest me too.
Huh?
I said, then you could arrest me too because wasn't I trespassing?
You all are trespassing. I'm telling you. You cannot hang out in the common area.
It
doesn't matter.
It's a common area.
It doesn't matter.
If it's a common area, then everyone's allowed to be.
No, that's not how this works.
Oh, and I really appreciate you yelling at my daughter.
So is a public park a common area? Is a public park a common area?
Yeah, it has curfews too.
Okay.
This is a common area, which means I can restrict your access to it.
There is nothing in my lease that says.
Yes, there is.
Yes.
So go inside your apartment or I'm going to charge you for trespass.
Trespass on my own.
You're going to want to put your gloves back in your pocket because you put your hands on any of us. You'll
they're refusing to cooperate.
I can wear my gloves anytime I want. It has nothing to do with you.
Yeah. So go inside your apartment.
Oh, hey, babe. Sorry.
See, my hands are going on.
That's us. You're going to stay
with
us.
Yes,
thank you.
Do
you need a code?
Okay, thank you.
Okay, well, we just came out because we heard it.
Yeah, but, you know, I do recognize you.
Yeah, I've talked to you before.
So
have you ever had problems with me or my children?
No.
Yeah.
I'm telling your guests to go inside. You were not involved over there.
Did my child?
You said go inside
from the property, the other property. Yes or no?
Your child was hanging on the fence.
Did she or did she not leave when asked to leave? Yes or no?
No, she did not.
Yes, she did.
No, she didn't. You don't.
Why is
it
on?
It is on.
You followed me all the way up here.
Right there. Okay. You're being audio and video recorded. I've already explained that to you.
Yes.
You are in a common area. You are going to go inside, or I'm going to charge you with trespass. I am the supervisor. He is a second supervisor.
Cool. Where's the police, dude?
Okay, I'll get them for you. That's how we're going to do this.
You might want to talk to your freaking haywire buddy there. I know that's not on you.
The kids want to be mouthy.
Because you were yelling at him.
Also, he said that he was going to arrest me.
Alright, so nothing's going on.
No.
Imagine an employee losing your credit card, but then painting you as the villain. What even is logic these days? We gave up on that. Just enjoy.
You just told me that you're not fond of me as a customer because you lost my credit card. Are you going to stand by that statement?
I didn't think that.
You just said we are not fond of customers like you because I'm upset because you lost my credit card over a driving when we drove in to get my prescription. You then tell me that you're not fond of me as a customer.
So
after you lose my credit card, that's okay?
So you think that it's okay that you're going to say that we suck?
Yes.
I mean, technically, we're here for you guys.
But you lost my card. That's not
human
being here for
error.
Me.
Mistakes happen.
Yeah, but that's fine.
And then you turn around and say it's my fault?
Talking to us about it.
Well, because you're talking to me.
Yes, because I'm understandably upset because you lost my credit card.
It's like, I mean, what do you literally want us to do? We went outside.
Find my credit card?
We went outside.
Or give us some kind of
a... Yeah, well, they're saying we suck and everything else. So if I was a
minute... We were about to leave, and you yelled over the aisle and said, we don't like customers like you.
Like that.
Okay.
Like that. Who get upset when you lose a credit card. You don't like customers who get upset.
We were already going to cancel our credit card. Because
I can almost guarantee...
Go through all that process.
If I wanted to say nothing, you guys would have continued stating
it. Oh, we're definitely going to continue to state it. We're going to make sure everyone knows that this Walgreens is not the best place to go because you lose our credit card. So, yes, I was upset, and I have every right to be upset. We drive through the drive-in. We're late at night. We're hungry. I just want my prescription. I didn't expect to have to go home now, cancel a credit card, and try to get a new one because you lost it. I understand human error. I just don't understand why. You have to yell back at me and say, we are not fond of customers like you. Let me be upset
not
during
like
this
you,
moment.
Like that.
Let
big
me
difference.
Be upset
that.
In the fact that you lost something
not
of
you
mine.
Like
let me
that.
Be upset about
big
it, difference. But don't retaliate against me like that. I am that customer. I am that customer who's upset because you lost my card. That's all. I'm upset because you lost a credit card. And we have to go through the process of now going and canceling it. So I'm upset and I have a right to be upset. You should at least be extremely understanding as the store who lost my credit card and let us walk out upset without telling me we aren't fond of customers like you or like that.
Well, do you think, Inc., that, you know, we're going to accept that what you said earlier about, you know, that they could have put it in their pocket?
Of course they could have. We don't know. Something happened.
We're not going
to steal. We have to cancel it because we don't know what happened.
We
you could have put
it in
a card. We're
not going to steal a customer's credit
You could have
card.
Given it to a wrong customer, and that customer could now be using my credit card. So we have to go take care of this issue, and it's frustrating because your store did it. That's all. Your store lost our card. All I expected was a sincere apology and to not tell us that you don't appreciate customers like that. Who get upset when you lose a card. Any one of these people would be upset. Would you be upset if they lost your credit card? Any customer who comes in here is
yeah,
going to be upset.
Yeah, I understand that.
If you lose it.
But when you're stating that, you're literally stating
I
that
said
we
you
stole
suck.
It.
No,
I said you suck.
No, but you say hey, that.
I said we don't know what happened to it. Someone could have put it in their pocket.
Exactly. You're literally stating that we are stealing
Well, you didn't
it.
Give it back to me. What am I supposed to think?
So
What
oh,
could
yeah.
have? Can you guarantee me that no one put it in their pocket? Can you guarantee that?
Yes,
no. You can't. You just because you know your customers, you know your employees, but you also can't tell me that why they lost it. You don't know why they lost it. You can't explain that. You have no explanation for what happened to it. That means you don't know where it is. You don't know if it's in a car driving down the road. You don't know if one of your customers dropped it and it went in the crack in your floor. You don't know if they put one of your people that work here put it in their bag. You know nothing about where my credit card is, or you'd get it for me. So. When we're upset, rightfully so, let us be upset. Don't tell us you're not fond of customers like that. You've ensured we'll never come back. I'll probably change my prescription to Albertsons, completely get away from Walgreens because of your statement. And I just want you to know that. And your manager, whoever that is, owner of Walgreens, wherever I have to escalate, it will be escalated.
1-800-WALGREENS.
Thank you. I will definitely call him. I will.
This guy, Karen, loses his senses on a plane. Now, we understand not getting your seat, but ruining the plane ride for everyone is not okay, man.
So you're going to take everybody off? He's going to make everybody get off now because he's not getting off.
Yeah.
I have kids. I have kids. That's nice to speak that way in front of my kids. That's really nice
blame
to speak
them.
That way in front of me.
Blame them.
I'm blaming you because you're going to make us all get off
yeah.
because you're
yeah.
not leaving.
Yeah.
That's ridiculous.
Because,
you didn't get your way. Wow. I understand she's supposed to have her seat. I understand that, but you're not going to disrupt it for everybody.
Oh, yes, we are.
Okay. I understand that. Jesus. I know. You're totally right. You should have your seat, but that you're going to make us all get off the flight.
No, he wants them to have
it. I have children. Jesus.
I know.
No, you... Oh. Roll top.
Oh, I love the smell of these. Oh, I would like. Wait, so what's happening here now, Mr. Customer Service?
We have to go. We have to leave. Baby, we have to leave.
Once we get off what?
We have to leave.
I can't hear you. Can you come closer?
Baby,
So wait a second. So we can reiterate. She paid $142 extra for an aisle seat because she has claustrophobia, and she has the worst case scenario against the wall. And now she wants.
This is a special one. We don't just have a Karen, we have a drunk Karen. And she's being an idiot on a plane, so the captain does what any sensible person would do and tells her to leave.
I'm here right now, and all I want to do is go. I just want to go to Vegas and just have fun. Excuse me. Bring him out here. Bring the captain out here. No, I'm not leaving. I am going on my trip. Bring the captain out here. I didn't do anything. Can you call him out here? Oh, I wasn't even loud. Can you guys vouch that I was allowed? I'm not leaving my flight. I am going to Vegas. And this is my trip. This is my sister's birthday. And I, no, you don't totally understand. It's my sister's birthday. I'm taking her to Vegas. I'm gonna go and have fun, and I don't want the captain to ruin my trip for me. Excuse me. What did I say? I didn't do anything. Can you? Excuse me. I am not raising my voice because right now you're disrespecting me and my flight and my money that I paid to go on this trip. You are disrespecting me at the moment. I am not going to listen to what the captain says. Bring the captain outside and tell, I want him to come outside and tell me to get my plane. Now this is disrespectful. What did I do? I don't want you to refund my ticket. I want you. No, I am leaving right now. I am going on this trip. What did I do? I didn't do anything. I'm so sorry. I want to know what I did that you are disrespecting my appearance right now. Explain to me. Excuse me. Outburst for what?
So they called the cops on the crazy drunk plane Karen. And did she leave quietly? Well, of course she didn't. She wouldn't be a Karen then, would she?
I didn't do anything. I didn't do anything. I don't understand what this outburst is coming from. Okay, what? She didn't do anything. I want to understand what I did. I want to know what the pilot saw that I did that he wants me off this plane. No, I don't care. It's my money. My money. I pay him to fly. So I want the pilot to come out. I want the pilot to come out and tell me what I did. I did not do anything wrong. I want the pilot to come out. I want him to show me how disrespectful I was. I didn't do anything. Excuse me? No, I don't want to be booked on another flight. This is my sister's birthday. I am on this flight. I want to be on this flight. I want to be in Vegas. Have fun. I don't understand what is his problem. I want him to come out. I really want him to come out. This plane will not leave. I will not leave until he comes out and tells me what I did. I want to know what I did. Please tell me what I did. Did I do anything? I want him to come out and tell me what I did. There is no citizen's arrest. I didn't do anything. I'm sitting here taking my sister to Vegas for her birthday. I don't know what I did.
Was she a counselor?
I don't know what I did.
He was sitting right next to
I
us.
I didn't do anything.
Well,
why are you here? Because the pilot is.
You are coming off, okay?
Why though? I want to know why.
It's not up to me. Okay? It's not up to the officers. It's up to the pilot.
Did I do anything wrong?
Yeah.
What did I do? Yeah. Fuck all of you!
Shut your mouth.
All of
Somebody move from.
Sorry, sister.
Officer, we got 2 seats. You guys can join us. Free tickets.
This woman claims that she has a disability and can't wear a mask and tries to bully this store into offering her service despite her not wearing a mask. Luckily, it didn't work. What a Karen.
All right, I have my items. I'm trying to check out at the store. I've just been shopping for about a half hour. Got all my things. And I'm just trying to check out. And the manager, are you the manager?
I'm the health and safety manager for the company.
Okay.
And by you acting like what you're doing, you've put the rest of the store and the other people here.
But you're violating my Americans with Disability Act rights. I'm trying to check out. You're arguing with me. You're within my 6 feet of space. And if you have a mask and it works, then what's the problem with me not having a mask?
Ma'am, you're not supposed to be in the store without a mask.
Yes, I am, because I have a breathing condition. You cannot deny me service due to a disability. It's Americans Disability Act. It's a $95,000 fine.
Ma'am,
I have medication, but you've actually, it doesn't matter. You have to provide service to people in wheelchairs, just like you have to provide service to me. You cannot deny me that. Are you saying you're going to deny me based on a disability because I cannot wear a mask? Is that what you're saying?
I'm saying
you're not
you are
gonna
not
let me
following
check
the laws that have been
There's no law.
There
no, sir,
law.
Don't yes, lie to me.
Is.
There is no law. Do you
we
know how a law
right to
is made?
Service to anyone
no,
who
you
not
don't. Not
our
based
rules.
On
yes,
a disability.
We yes, we do.
Not based on a disability.
Yes, we do.
You do not have the right to deny me service based on a disability.
If we have a facility that is set up for the regulations that have been put forth.
I've been standing here arguing with longer than it would have taken me to check out. So it's not about that, and you cannot deny me service based on a disability. What part of that don't you understand? It's a $95,000 fine.
Ma'am, do you have a membership?
For the Americans Disability Act.
Do you have a membership?
Yes, I do.
We'll pick that up at the membership counter, okay?
I'm
we cannot allow people to come into our facility.
I have my items. I want to leave, and you will not let me leave with my items.
Ma'am, look at that insurance. Do you have some proof of your medical condition?
That's against my HIPAA. So you want to know my medical condition? Is that because that's a $25,000 fine on top of the $95,000 fine? Yeah, it is. You cannot ask me about my medical condition. You don't know the law, sir. So please don't quote it because I do. I do know my rights. I do know the law. You're telling me wearing a mask is the law, and that's wrong. Wearing a mask is not a law.
Can we make sure that we get our membership information and we'll just turn this over to the authorities?
It's an executive order. It's not a law.
Thank you so much. We really appreciate it.
You need to check me out. You're denying me service.
She tipped this man, but he decided that wasn't enough and used her credit card on a vending machine. A precarious situation, to say the least.
So I just tipped you $5. You just found my credit card in my car, and now you in here swiping my credit card on your vending machine? Did you not just get something out of the vending machine? Did you not find my credit card on the floor? Give me my card. Literally, I just got a thing saying something about a vending machine. Don't even sit here flat. You literally just took and give me my $5 back.
Here.
Thank you. And my card. Where's my card? Gee, how dishonest and fucked up is this? It's no way. It's nothing. Gee, listen. Where the manager go?
Wait. Can you listen?
It's nothing.
I
just literally tipped this man and turned around and tipped you.
I didn't know.
And then you asked me if you needed it. It was on my floor. It was on the floor. I literally saw it before I got out the car and I forgot.
Outside of the car.
Okay, so it ain't no protocol when y'all found somebody's where you like, oh, I found somebody's credit card. Manager, I found someone's card while I'm here at work. It's no other right, so you take them. Vending machine and use them? That's crazy. No, I got my $5 back. But I'll be talking to Crossbar about this. Because what that was. Gee, I don't need your money.
Whatever money I spent on there.
You probably needed it because you're sitting here with money in your pockets. I just gave you $5 and you still decide to swipe my credit card that you just got out of my car that I just tipped you for cleaning.
That's why I'm trying to give you money. money. So whatever money I
keep the money card, because what I'm going to do is contact CarSpot.
I know it's not going to make
right. So you might need your money now. Period. Enjoy your. But at the end of the day, that was foul because I'm a really honest person. I gave him, I tipped him. I said, your folks helped you clean the car? He said, yeah. I walked all the way back here so I could give you money. And you sitting in here stealing from me like my phone ain't going to notify me that somebody needs car. Serious, that's. You don't apologize. Like, you don't get. That's ridiculous. Phillips. I can't believe that. And I look at my phone, I'm like, self. Because earlier I thought I lost. My boyfriend said, your car in the back, on the back seat. Yeah. I said, all right, I'll grab it before. And then I get out the car, I completely get. Yeah. And then I come here, tip you, and you stand at the machine using my car. 8295. And then people do that while they at work. You don't know about me. You don't know nothing about me. Hey, but you work here. That's crazy. I appreciate you, love.
This woman is blaming this guy for pulling the emergency bar while simultaneously doing it herself. An absolute idiot and bully. And we hope she got what she deserved.
Yeah, yeah. One more picture, stupid idiot.
One more. Dude, yeah. You're the
what you gonna do to the
you know what?
Yeah.
No one's going nowhere now because of you. Okay. No, because of you.
Look at her.
You see, yeah,
you're
f***ed up. Because of you.
At a McDonald's drive-thru, this woman loses her mind. Who's gonna tell these Karens that it's never this serious?
I want my money back!
What's more satisfying than seeing a Karen get their attitude served to them on a silver platter? Nothing, in our opinion. These people are crazy, and the best part is, they think they're right. And because we know you love seeing that too, here's a compilation of Karens going back crap crazy, and subsequently getting put into their place. Watch what this woman does when the employee shuts the window after being shouted on. Spoiler, it's something only a Karen would do. Working in retail is a nightmare. This guy is an absolute tool to his employees. But thanks, everyone loves him. Employees are accusing him of taking their tips, and we believe them after looking at his conduct.
Money. You think I want your tips? I s**t on it. If you don't make the money,
what are you
going
to
do? You make $70-$80 a day. You make $5.
Why? Call her stupid, Sal.
She doesn't know how. Look, when the customer comes in.
Stupid, yes?
Listen, yes, I did, because she don't make no money. And that gets on me.
Why? When the
customer
don't get
comes,
the money.
You're supposed to give
them grace.
Anna, you heard the whole thing. Please, do not justify this action. Why do you work here?
Oh, jeez.
This boss?
I
know you need to work. You'll make more money in a factory.
Hold on.
Ooh.
Yes, let's do
it. You witnessed it.
Mm-hmm.
We call each other stupid.
No.
You just
do you want to see?
We call each other stupid.
For 5 minutes. We heard it all.
That
it doesn't matter. I told you the conversation.
Oh, jeez.
Respectful.
Do you understand?
Off the tip, guys.
Why are they screaming at each other?
Everybody loves me.
Everybody loves me.
Get the fuck out, both of you guys.
He just went out. He got mad.
Has no problem making a public issue of it. Peak Karen behavior.
Hey. Baby mama's standing like a stink.
Yeah, you were wrong for trying to block me too.
Yup,
it is.
Something
Snickers some days.
No, I don't eat Snickers. I used to be
for you.
Yeah, you get it.
You
know, I used to be like, keep talking about
This man has been accused of stealing from this store, and judging by his reaction, we're sure he did it. Such denial can only mean guilt.
I'm not leaving your store. Bro, I got money. I want to buy something. I want to buy something.
No, you can't.
I'm staying right here except for that. I'm buying my burrito. I'm buying my donut and everything. Stop me from not paying. Call the police. You disgraced me, man. You violated my civil rights. Each time I come, you say I stole from your store. I got money in my pocket all the time I come, shop from you. You never saw me steal from you, man.
Get out, please.
What are you gonna do?
Out, bro. Come on, man.
No, I'm staying right here. I'm shopping. If you want to pay, that's the time I'll be high. Nobody's going to take me. I'll pay for this. Why you take my picture? For waiting. By the police. You stupid ass. I need a lighter. Yeah, Thomas Walker. You want to see my ID? Take my picture. Who want to come here? He said I stole from your store. Call it. Yeah, matter of fact, I'm going to call the police. I'm gonna call the police. You don't have to. I will call the police.
They're already coming,
right? Yeah, they come. I'll make sure they come because all the time you say you're gonna do it, you never do. I will call them. They have a record on you. You disgrace my civil rights, man. I will call them, dude.
Nobody's gonna take you, bud. Why you
bothering? You said I stole from the store.
You steal all the time.
Who you steal all the time, dude? I can live in a house. I got a mansion. Yeah. I got gold and diamonds on my. I'm in a movie. Who the fuck are you? Huh? I'm in a movie, man, right here in Santa Clara County. I'll call the police when I get out. What you got behind your hand? What you got behind you? Take it out. What you got behind you? Huh? But what you keep your hand behind there for? Huh?
Okay, go ahead. Handle this.
I'm not leaving your store, dude. I want to shop. I'm not leaving your store.
Come on.
I don't want to shop. I'm not leaving your store. Who me? I'll tell you right now. I'm not leaving your store. I'm going to shop. Okay, you want to stop? You want me to stop? I'm in the scene. Call the police. I'll call the cops. I was saying, yell at dude. You don't want to do that to me. I stole from the store. Do you know where I am when you say that to me?
Anytime anyone says liberal piece of poop is an insult, you know that person is a joke. This guy really gives so this Karen a verbal beatdown, and we love it.
Dude, you're going on YouTube. Get the out of here. Don't come to my window. Don't come up to my window and talk to me like that. Someone needs to teach you respect. Get the out of here. Dude, you know what? You deserve it. Okay?
How do I deserve it?
You deserve it for acting like this, for thinking you need to come up to my window and chew me out. You're sitting back there, dude. You see this line? Okay?
Yes,
you're sitting way back there. You're sitting way back there. Okay?
Look,
yeah, now you are. Because you pulled right up to my window. Get the. I'm conservative. I'm conservative. No. You dare threaten me, you dirty old man. Someone ought to teach you some respect.
Bring it,
dude. Please. I would whoop your ass, but I don't beat up old men.
Please.
I'm elderly. Yeah, you, and dude, little, you say whatever the hell you want. You got this old, tired, blade. You're old, depreciated man. You should freaking learn how to get some money in this life, you dirty old man.
Try and run up when we put our card in.
We're gonna sit here.
The classic, I do not need permission to tape you. Get ready for more of the same up next.
Lazy again. Go ahead.
Sure. I can also tell you that I don't give you permission to tape me.
I didn't ask for your permission.
You
in the state of New York, I do not need your permission.
No, I do not.
I want a manager.
I am a manager.
Bill.
And please give the bag back.
No.
We have here a woman who decides that she deserves a refund for her soup and decides to be as annoying as humanly possible about it.
I need this coffee returned, and I need my bowl of soup returned. Whatever that soup was, I need it returned. Return what I ate. Return my food. Refund my money. Refund my money. Refund my money. Hello? Can you please refund my money?
This worker also uses the "you don't have permission to tape me" card, which we all know is nonsense. The customer rightly asks for the manager.
You came, you bust in the room, you didn't knock, you did not. It's not against the law.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
It's evidence. That's what it's called.
Exactly.
Because I'm asking you.
No, you're very rude. You're very rude. But I still want your manager.
Okay, you can call tomorrow and we'll talk to you.
Nope. I'm pretty sure y'all have a cell phone. His cell phone number.
I
want corporate.
I can't give you his number. You're afraid.
You're afraid of us to talk to your
manager? Yeah, that's what it is.
Do you want your refund? Because he told me to give it to you.
We want the refund.
Then I'm giving it to you. Then you can leave.
But I still want to speak with your supervisor.
You can call them tomorrow.
Okay. Mm-mm.
Okay, then you won't be able to come back on property.
I don't want to stay in here, honey.
Can you just stop?
No.
I'm going to give you your refund back.
Nope.
You're going to be escorted off and trespass off the property.
I'm not going to be anything. I'm not going to be anything. No, I won't.
That's a problem. We ain't got to stay.
No, I don't care about staying here.
What I'm saying,
we haven't even been here 10 minutes.
Shoot, they terrible. My God.
In this clip, a poor customer tries to get a manager's name for not letting his sick mother sit down. However, she threatens to call the cops on him for it. We're as confused as you are.
How can you run a store, an establishment, and not have the number to corporate?
Because I don't Google it.
Because you don't Google it? You're the manager here.
Yeah.
What is your name? What is your name, Miss Manager? Manager, what's your name? You don't have to give your that information, and you're a manager.
Yep, that's all the information.
Really? So the well-being of your customers is not your concern. Being a manager and giving out proper information is not your concern. Well, it doesn't matter if it's your concern or not, because this is going to corporate. You can call the cops, because corporate's getting this video. So what's your name, manager?
Manager.
What's your name? What's your name? I've got it on the receipt as far as the address, and I've got her associates' names on my receipt, but Miss Manager doesn't want to do her job properly. And she walked away. And she walked away.
Because the bathroom
was the least. I told you I had a sick mother and I needed a place for her to sit because she's diabetic. That was the least of the concern was the restaurant. It doesn't matter. Your concern and your professionalism is poor. It's poor.
And now you're harassing me?
It's not harassment because I'm asking for a corporate number from the manager.
I don't have it, so Google it.
The manager should be able to give me a phone number to contact her bosses, her superiors, so that we can rectify this the proper way.
I don't have a cell phone with your men, so feel free to call.
But you don't have to have the cell phone. If you're a manager, you should have a list of phone numbers and contacts for any kind of emergency within this establishment.
It's a 1-800 number. Feel free to look it up.
That's all we need, and we've got
it.
Yeah, that's all I need.
And
I don't know why you don't think
your lack of empathy is really.
And I did come into her store, and I did purchase what I needed. So it wasn't like I came in to use her restroom. I came in, I made a purchase from this store, here's my receipt, and yet this manager still refuses to give me the time of day.
I refuse to look up a number on the internet. Take that for your video and get out of my store.
This is not your store because you don't even have a number to corporate.
Okay,
so I can't even take it that this is your store.
I can't
take it that this is your store if you can't provide me any information.
This isn't your store.
Okay, then find someone else who it is. I'm a manager of this building.
You're the manager of this building. Oh, now you're being rude. You know that's grounds for corporate to terminate you. You can't treat anybody like that.
I was a manager for Motorola for many years.
Oh, we will.
You need to go to school.
She just needs to be a human, my God. Nobody here doing anything that's asking for anybody to go through extreme measures. Just a little courtesy. A little professionalism goes a long way. So there's no reason for you to be in a position.
You never even answered when I said I was diabetic and needed a place to sit.
Well,
and all you did was go,
But I don't have somewhere for you to sit, ma'am.
Well, you know, I found some boxes that carry detergent.
Well, I'm glad you didn't fall off the boxes, but they're not chairs.
Well, you could have thought of that.
There we go. Miss, quote-unquote, wannabe manager has left the building once again, leaving us here with nobody to talk to, of authority, no power, of any type of cooperation.
We will.
Oh, yeah, I definitely will. But I'm definitely going to document you for as much time as I possibly can.
And also for not wearing your mask.
Yes, and not wearing a mask.
Have a nice day.
Oh, I will have a nice day. It's getting nicer.
Hi. Hi, I just ordered here and there's mold on my bread. I want a refund.
Mold on my bread.
For my whole meal.
Damn, what is it in my whole meal? Mm.
And smell it. Tell me if that smells right to you. Smell the top bun.
That's not mold, that's flour.
That's the bottom bun. I'm talking about the top. There's green on there.
And like four areas.
And like four areas.
And smell it. Put it up to your nose, pull your mask down and smell it. It doesn't even smell right. I want my money back. And I want to talk to a manager as well.
I am, and you're acting like a psycho.
So you let your cooks give people molded bread?
No, absolutely not. But things happen, and I am sorry about that.
You can open that sandwich and see. You better give me my money back or I'm calling corporate.
Call the police.
Give me my receipt. Give me my receipt now. We have you on video.
She did not just lock the door.
Give me my money back.
Stephanie, yes! Quit.
We have you on video and we're calling corporate, dumb.
Good
I
God.
Can't believe her, how she treated you that way.
And she kept my receipt. So I just wasted money at that place. I'm pissed.
This woman couldn't stand two kids just doing that, being kids. While driving around in a mobility scooter isn't the best thing in the world, threatening someone is something only a Karen would do in this situation.
Don't sit on those things.
Are you normal?
No, but I defend people that have a right to those. There's not enough of these in the store. If you're not disabled, you don't use those.
I mean, there ain't a law against it.
Yes, there is, as
there's
a matter of fact.
There is?
Yes.
What's the law then?
If you're not handicapped, you don't use one.
But
use your brain for 2 seconds.
There's a law for that?
There's not really a law.
It's called the American Disability Act.
Here, I'm gonna look that up right quick.
Don't get smart, G. Don't get smart.
Hey, my phone's dead. Can I use your phone?
No, dude.
Oh, my phone's
dead. My phone is like...
I don't care.
Well, I don't care.
Put it back where you got it from.
Oh,
now.
No, so, oh, okay, don't even put it back, dude. He's being a free spirit.
Later.
If I see that thing's not back and you're still on, you know, help me God, you get thrown on.
Alright, do it.
This Karen decided that she was too good to follow COVID protocols and wear a mask. Big props to the shop owners for refusing her service. True patriots in our eyes.
Pay me the car.
Please leave the building. No. Get out of, ma'am, I do not want to have to call the police on you.
Go ahead.
You're asking me to leave.
Corporate number.
We're in the middle of a pandemic. Do not. Are stuck, ma'am.
Okay. Corporate
leave.
Number.
Leave. Get
corporate
out.
Number.
You want me to call 911?
Go ahead. Corporate
ma'am.
Number. Give me the card.
I don't have the card.
You are making a scene.
Then give it to me.
Come here, ma'am.
He's getting you
no, but you can't
please.
Require me to work.
Right to refuse service. Please come leave. On. Please leave.
Go ahead.
To the court.
Go ahead.
Please leave.
Go ahead.
Ma'am. Other people here are trying to be
now.
Served. I do not want to have to call
give
police.
Me
please
number.
Leave.
Give me your number.
No, that's fine.
Ma'am.
Give it to
I'm
me.
Sorry.
We have a policy to keep the staff
sorry.
Here
I
safe.
I
know
that
you don't care.
But
she
cares.
It's not
got.
About you. It's about all the other people.
Thank
here.
You very much.
Have a nice day.
Karen isn't a gender-specific term. Look at this man refusing to come out of the Stone Age and use an app to buy his stuff, claiming he's mentally exempt from wearing a mask. Absolute idiot.
No, I'm an idiot. That's an idiot, dude.
He doesn't need to be over here. I will call the
prosecutor
and exit my store. I am not doing a cash transaction outside. What's your name? Michelle. Yes.
And what's his name?
Christopher. I'm a manager.
And what's your name?
I'm the manager.
Mm-hmm. You're telling me... I can't buy that for what reason now?
Because I'm not doing a cash transaction. I'm not
curbside service like everyone else is doing.
You have to do it through the phone. Mm-hmm.
I don't do the app. I pay cash money.
But we're not.
Do you understand
allowed.
That, little girl?
Are you
guys on drugs?
No.
Am I missing something?
Oh, no,
I'm not.
Okay,
and watch
I will
your
call
mouth,
the cops. I will. Over and fine. I will call the cops if you don't exit my store. You keep using vulgar language. There is a child right there.
What vulgar language?
I'm not repeating it.
Are you? Get the boss, man.
Are you? Get the boss.
My family are all litigators. This is bull. You're doing this to the wrong guy. You want to get your boys out here and we can smooth this over?
Litigators.
And I'm telling you, I cannot wear the mask. I'm medically exempt. Do you understand that?
There's no medical exemption.
I can go get a
yes, there is. Mr. Smart Pants, you don't know what you're talking about.
Listen to pulmonologist.
You're what? What did you say? Your husband? Let me have a good look at you.
Is it all right?
Oh, I'm going to have some fun with this one.
Is he okay?
I absolutely am.
In this video, this kid just pulled up to a pizza place and started having
yeah,
a problem
feel
with
like
everyone
a motherfucker.
Inside. Not just a Karen, but one that's especially unhinged. And then she asks if she can have ice cream. What a lunatic.
He's gonna cut his ass, nigga. Oh, man. Jeez Louise. Oh, boys. All right, boys. Oh, man. Oh, I catch on that flippy dippy. Well, that's a that motherfucking nap. That nap so good with you motherfucking sweat. You sweat a little bit. A little sweat going on over here. But that nighttime sweat. Not a sweat, but a sweat. You know what I'm talking about? That's that Keith sweat. That's what Keith sweat was talking about, motherfucker. That's the R&B shit. All right. That R&G shit. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, man, I'm about to dolphin dive in the bed, though. Y'all already know. And look, man, she watch while I get in the motherfucking bed. What black pussy is? Black pussy? Black pussy? With a black boy around here somewhere. Goddamn it, when I get in the motherfucking bed, to watch black pussy get there. Oh, he in his box. Black pussy get in the box sometimes. A little cat box in the tree. Yeah, he in the box now. But goddamn. When he see me in the bed, boy, he gonna be like, hey, bedtime. He gonna hop in the bed. Shit, the other night, black pussy like hopped in the bed instantly. Like, usually it take a second. Like, I'd be laying in bed, and sometimes he'll fucking see me and be like, oh, asleep. And then he'll fucking hop over there by me. But goddamn, one night, the other night, it was instant. But as soon as I motherfucking hopped in the bed, he said, hey, he's asleep. He hopped there right behind me. I said, shit. But pussy, you know what time it is. Come on. So when I ain't having my mind, tell me front is back.
I'm reacting already before the shit even set. Honking me driving, you just scared a finger. Digging and sagging, dipping in traffic, trying not to lose my temper. I ain't drinking from medicine, I ain't tooting no powder. Might have smoked me a little weed, always look like I'm shabba. Trying to get where I gotta, ricochet like a hollow. I'm seeing like some trouble, which I done seen a whole lot of. Like a fly on the wall.
I could even get you.
See police and I'm gone. I'm trying to get them to lose me. No matter what was at stake.
Had to do what to do.
I made it out to LA laying and I had nothing to lose. My landlord giving me help.
And I'm moving a few. And I say it's all good if you ask how you doing.
It's like a predator, man. I'm just waiting my moment. Anything in due time, man. Everything but my sake.
That remix. Oh, man. All boobs and titties up, man. Shout out to everybody. Y'all already know if you didn't. Too many titties, y'all. Too many.
Better keep strapped and thinking lottos. Keep it going, egging on, double up like that. It's a combo. Here, what you waiting on? Making calls, do it at the crack of dawn. If you're trying to do this shit up now, we ain't even got to wait until tomorrow. Everything in due time ain't
nothing, I'ma wait until it's my go. You can tell me I'm tripping, I'm smoking load of cigars, though. Sitting back thanking God nowadays, I ain't worried about 5-0. Sticking trouble for a 5, and they bust going for a 50. See him dibble dabbling with lives. Got it going for you, get me. Cause I'm here for my folks, here for my looks, here for my city. Long time coming up, I ain't finna let it get up. Think Gator with your tough skin, got a quick bite, put your chillers off. Think Gator, get up. Think Gator, get up. Think Gator, get up. Zigzagging in traffic, hunking me, you just get a finger. Stand up, not a savage. Go get it, man, I'm not a killer. Butterfly from a caterpillar. Meaning making all my dreams real. From a storage up into a villa, man, you imagine how this feel. No permissions in the powder. Smoking, we looking like Shaba. Ricochet from a hollow tip, man, trying to make it where I gotta. Being tough came easy. High stress from the beginning. 17 posted with the best, man, that young and mean business. Batteries posted in his back. OG's trying to reach him. Got shot thinking, oh well, tough skin, never play victim. Crying hard thinking to myself up until something feels different. And like I get a look at submerged, I'm just laying low with a vision. Till it's different. Like a gator looking submerged, I'm just laying low with a vision. Think gator, get up. 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 Submerged, I'm just laying low with a vision. Think gator, get up. Hey yo, it's ricochet full of these beasts. Remember one thing. Lock your jaw. Think gator, get up. Tough it out. Think gator, get up. Grow some gator skin.
Little Stevie, get out of there, goddammit, looking at ass the whole time. No, Little Stevie, that was you, goddammit. Little Stevie, no, I'm not just yelling your name and trying to act like it's you doing it when it's really me. And no, I ain't trying to do that. Little Stevie, stop looking at booty. We don't do that around here, goddammit. Jesus fucking Christ, Little Stevie, you trying to keep it professional.